All right, we should be streaming. I don't know if this thing picked up just yet, but we're gonna do a masterclass in beat making. If you're new here, I'm Game from BusyWorksBeats.com. We've trained over 700,000 producers around the world. Some have gone to work with Drake, Young Thug, Post Malone, YG, Ray Shremmer, Ariana Grande, French Montana, if I didn't already say that, NBA YoungBoy, and on and on and on. A lot of Billboard charting artists. So this live stream is all about you, and I recently did a poll on my Instagram. And I realized our content is sometimes too advanced because we're talking to people who are on a high level. So what I'm going to do right now is talk to the people who are just starting, and we're going to learn how to make beats live, step by step, and really get through the process, the step by step of how to make beats. So this is a masterclass. We're going to go through all the little nuances and all the, really what you're going to learn today is what you don't need to know. That sounds crazy. You're going to learn today what you don't need to know. And what I mean by that is you're going to get distracted by all the plugins and all the settings that people talk about. But in reality, beat making comes down to about three main things. And we'll get down to it. What's up, Alex? RK is here. Charlie Smith is here. Ryduane, what's up? One and only, welcome. Pramodini, you guys got some hard names. We're getting harder and harder every week. Mavi Beaton. Satesi, welcome. Nikilita. Man, this is hard. I'm failing this spelling test. BJ, what's going on? Give me a second, guys. All right, so let's get this thing rocking. I'm not going to waste too much time. We're going to get straight to it. Again, this is a beat making masterclass. If you just joined us, I'm Game from BusyWorksBeats.com. We've trained over 700,000 producers around the world. Some are going to work with Drake, Young Thug, Post Malone, YG, Ray Shremmer, and Ariana Grande, French Montana. A lot of Billboard charting artists. And because they've taken the knowledge and they've applied it. And so again, what you're going to learn today is what not. You're going to learn, how do I phrase it? You're going to learn today what not to do, if that makes sense. You're going to learn what not to focus on so that you can only have three main things to focus on, and then you'll end up making beats a lot faster. Because again, you're learning from a lot of tutorials that show you all this stuff that in reality is like super minutia. Okay, so the first thing really is music theory. If you don't understand simple minor major chords, you're going to have a tough time coming up with melodies specifically. But the good news is that you don't need to learn about dominant seventh chords, augmented chords, diminished chords, borrowed chords, key modulation. That's cool if you want to learn that, and you can learn that at busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. But for the most part, you're only using two chord types, major and minor. You're not using all these variations of chords. Like, rarely do you use those. And really, it's as simple as that. So let's open up some plugins. Another thing I realized the beginners have an issue with is that they don't have the right sounds. So I'm gonna tell you what not to do in beat making so that you can stop wasting time listening to people telling you all this simple stuff. So in FL Studio, the problem is it's not built for our type of music. Okay, so I'll say that one more time. FL Studio is not built for our type of music, like the hip hop, modern chart topping music. It's made for EDM, kind of electronic music. So all the sounds in FL Studio, you're going to have a tough time trying to turn them from EDM sounds into trap sounds. It just does not work that way. And we've tried it many times. I tried to take an acoustic drum kit and make it sound trap, and it did not sound trap at all. There's something about trap that has to have certain samples, or else we don't perceive it as trap. And I'm going to teach you how to do more than trap today. We're going to do UK drill, we're going to do trap, and we're going to do sample beats today. So please hold me to that UK drill. I'll write it down so I don't forget. UK drill, trap, and what did I say? Sample. So I'll keep my own notes so that we don't forget. So again, I can try to make a Chick-fil-A sandwich with peanut butter and jelly, but the odds of that happening are extremely slim. Okay, it's going to take a lot of work to convert a peanut butter and jelly sandwich into a Chick-fil-A sandwich. It's a lot easier when we start with the actual chicken and the actual bread that Chick-fil-A uses. And that's the biggest problem you guys have. You're trying to turn EDM sounds into trap sounds, and that's why you're struggling so much. So I'll show you the stock plugins that give you some sounds that we use. And ironically, it's called FL Keys, which is super funny because I've heard a lot of hit songs using FL Keys. Now, what I didn't know, what I just found out, is that they have presets. So if you go to the presets, you can cycle between different piano types. So let me get my pedal here so I can play some chords for you. So the broken piano is a little detuned, it's called, like a little, sounds like a cowboy saloon. It's very detuned. Go to the next piano, it's called compressed piano. This one's gonna give you a very squash sound. Okay, so just very squashed, kind of the same sound but squashed. Concert seems cleaner and wider. So they're very subtle. A dance piano is very centered and very energetic sounding. It's meant for like quick playing like this. Or let's do something. The only thing about a plugin list is that you guys create so many genres of music, it would be unfair to give you a plugin list to say these are the best plugins. It's just not that simple when it comes to sounds. But I will give you a one sound plugin. It's pretty cheap. It's called Expand 2. It looks like this. So if I had to plug one plugin for the price and the value of the sounds, I would say Expand 2. But other sound sources, I can't really give you a specific thing because everybody creates a different style of music. So dance piano is really good, and let's go. And again, this FL Keys has been used on top records, and I might recreate one of the patterns if I remember it. Dark piano, again, you could use dark melody stuff like. It's a little sensitive with the keyboard, but you get the idea. Plain piano is their normal preset. School piano, I don't know. And the default is the. So barely any difference. Then they have an E piano, which is like R&B. So this, you can get the majority of basic sounds through FL Keys. I know people talk about Sakura, but you have to remember, I don't want to go down the deep end because I could spend all day talking about this stuff. But FL Studio is free, but it comes with a lot of stuff in demo mode. And if you get the producer edition of FL Studio, you still have things like Harmore or Sakura, but it's in demo mode. So it's pointless to use because you can't really use it. You have to buy it. And a lot of people don't have it. So that's how you get the R&B piano. So today we're going to focus on, it's called dance piano. You've heard this a gazillion. Red Lot. Or whatever the song is. They use this a gazillion times. This is the TikTok piano, if you didn't know. I'm trying to think of another song that uses a TikTok. Yeah, I'd recommend buying the producer edition if you're going to go FL Studio. FL Studio, just for those who just joined in, FL Studio is just a big canvas. That's all it is. It's one big canvas that we love. Now, as far as the paint and the paintbrush, you have to get that elsewhere. But I think it's one of the best canvases for making beats. It might not come with the best paint set for making your type of beats, but it's the best canvas in my opinion. What's going on? So let's get into beat making. So I wanted to get, you know, clear the myths out of your head so that you're not chasing something that's not there. Because I have thousands of plugins just to give you an idea. Let's pull up my plugin manager. I have 1600 plus plugins, and this is a new computer. On my other computer, I had a ton as well. And these are all purchased and all those different things. So I've seen all the plugins. I've seen what they can do. I've seen what they promise. And you don't really need all those. The ironic part about having all these sound making plugins is that I barely use them, which is crazy. Okay, so without further ado, let's talk about the two things you need to know, major and minor chords. How many people are here? Are you guys ready to get started? Is my internet rocking? Okay, we got enough people in here that I can start getting into it. So thank you everybody for hopping in. Again, this is a beat making masterclass. Soon we're going to have a beat mixing masterclass as well. So I'm just giving you the core basics, because what I realized is that I started teaching for the advanced people. So the people who were just starting felt like they were left out because they didn't know what the heck was going on. So this is going to be for people who are advanced and beginner, because advanced people know that you need to revisit the basics over and over and over and over and over again, the fundamentals constantly, or else you're not going to evolve. Okay, so let's get down to it. We have, again, to get here, we're going to go to our channel rack, which is right here. Open up what's called FL Keys with a plus icon. Just go down to FL Keys. Shout out to Brandon Spencer. Thank you for your super chat. It says keep what you're doing. Thank you. Go to FL Keys. If I can spell here. Oh, here it is. FL Keys. Then open it up. Go to your presets. Go to, we're on dance piano right now, if you want to follow along. So the next step is to start organizing your sound. This is a good habit to build. So in FL Studio, if you hit Alt or Option M on Mac, it hides or reveals what's called the target mixer track. You don't need to know the exact name. It's basically a number to the left side of your sounds. And what this little thing means is where the sound is routed. And this is important when we get into mixing and sound design as we're mixing. So a good habit is hit Control L to automatically send that sound to the mixer. And what it does is, if you click this button, the mixer button, it sends it to the mixer and it starts accounting for the sound. Because if you don't have a number assigned to your sound, it goes to the master track. And that's not good when you're trying to create multi-tracks for your track and send it out to people. Okay, it's a long explanation, but you want to have every sound be accounted for in the mixer somewhere, so that you can edit the sound. Okay, so now let's talk about the two primary chords, I'll say. Right click, let's go to piano roll. We have a major chord and we have a minor chord. Now this sounds so basic, but again, this is the foundation of all things music theory when it comes to the modern music that we make. Again, there are other chord types like dominant seventh, augmented chords, diminished chords. We talked about chord extensions like seventh, ninths, 11ths, 13ths. There are a lot of different chords, sixth chords. You know, you have tritone, there's a lot of things. But the point is, the two major ones that we always use are major and minor, always. And more so minor chords than major chords, now that we're in this style of music that we're in today. So I'll show you how to make a major chord and minor chord with your eyes closed. Literally, I'm going to close my eyes and just pick a random note. It really doesn't matter. So wherever you land, this is considered the zero point. Okay, this is called the point of rest, the point where there's no distance. Okay, so just call it the zero point. All we have to do now is count up our keyboard. So we're going upward. Okay, and we're just going to count note by note. And as long as you can count, you can create a minor or a major chord or whatever the chord type is. So there's a certain DNA structure to a major chord, and I've mapped this out. You can actually get this chord code chart for free and download it straight to your phone, put it on as a wallpaper, whatever. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/music-theory. It's a free chord code chart, and I give you the DNA for each chord. So for example, the major chord is 0-4-7. So wherever you land is considered zero. Okay, so it's a point of no distance. All we have to do now is count up our keyboard note by note. What's up, Andy? Not here to get distracted by the chat. So unless you have a major question, you know, hold it till the end. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So all you got to do is count up your keyboard. Again, starting at 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So as long as the only thing you need to memorize is the major, because from the major chord, you basically get everything else. Okay, so the major chord is 0-4-7. And I'll show you what that means. So a lot of people try to tell me that method is terrible to teach people because there's these things called scale degrees that are called the third and the fifth and the fourth. Notice there's a TH after all the words and an RD, third, second, fourth, fifth. I'm not talking about scale degrees. And just to prove it to those music theory snobs that are out there, how important these chord codes are, let's create a chord using the exact system we just did through sound design. Okay, so let's go to preset. Let's clear this thing out. So again, zero is a semitone value. It just gives us whatever note we're playing. So you only have one note playing. Now what happens if I add another note in here? Now they're both trying to play the same note. What's up, DJ Ray? Okay, so they're clashing. But what happens if I take this second sound and I turn the note up to four? It's called a major triad. Now I'm playing the root note and a major major third. We're playing the root note and a major third. So it's actually two tones being played, even though I'm playing one note on my keyboard. Now what happens if we add a third sound in here? And this is all using the DNA of chords. This is why it's so important to understand chord codes, because this applies to sound design as well. Now I'm going to add a third sound, and it's going to play the third note. So it's 0-4-7. So now when I play one note on my keyboard, I'll even prove this by going to the screen here. That's not the right plugin. I'm clicking on one note, but it's creating three sounds. And it's a major chord. Now what happens if we go a little more advanced and then we add the major seventh, which is 11. So it's 0-4-7-11. And to get there, we would have to go up one octave, which is 12 semitones, and then down one note. So 12 minus one is 11 semitones. So now every note that I hit, it creates a major seven chord, even though I'm playing one note. And this is how you get those house chords and pads. Okay, so that's the power of chord codes. It goes way beyond just how to make a simple major chord. You can actually apply this to sound design. You can apply it to the harmonic series. There's so many things you could apply this to. We don't want to get too deep down the rabbit hole. Okay, so 0-4-7. I just wanted to show you the power of the chord codes, because this is a basic thing and it's an advanced thing at the same exact time. The same way DNA is pretty simple once you understand DNA, but DNA makes humans. We're pretty advanced. You know, so it starts with the basic fundamentals. So we have G, B, D, and this is our major chord. Now, what's the difference between a major chord and a minor chord? The only difference, and this is why I said, once you understand a major chord, you can pretty much understand every chord type. The only difference between a major chord and a minor chord is that the middle note goes down one. Now, again, I have to give you a little caveat, and we do have a full advanced music theory masterclass in our new premium section. If you go to premium.busyworksbeats.com, the link should be in the video description. But I brought on not only myself, but like a master in music theory. He plays, I think, 12 plus instruments, and he talks about the harmonic series. He talks about modes. We talk about certain scales that give you certain moods. We talk about a lot of high level stuff. And in doing that, I started to realize how important chord codes are to the whole picture. Okay, but one thing we talked about is that how musicians learn music is they learn by shape. So if I pick up my keyboard, you know, it's very visual. I'm looking at it straight ahead. You know, I'm looking at the three note combinations all bundled together. The problem is with digital music, no, it's not called Music Theory in a Day, but that is included with our premium at premium.busyworksbeats.com. I'm actually talking about the masterclass section. What's up, Able Beats? The masterclass section has another added Music Theory masterclass to it. So you should go check it out if you're a premium member. So the thing is, when musicians learn, they learn by shape. Okay, so I'm giving you the shortcut so you don't have to waste time trying to understand why everything is the way it is. Musicians learn by shape because, again, they're looking at the keyboard straight on. Us producers, we're not looking at the keyboard straight on. In order to do that, I would have to turn my head like this. And that's not how we produce. We don't produce like this. We don't produce with our head turned. So we have to do things differently when it comes to writing out the notes. It's just a whole different game because we can't learn by shape. So this is why the system is so powerful. So the main way I remember a major chord going to a minor chord is just taking this middle note in the triad, or the three note chord, tri meaning three, and just pulling it down one so that it's a minor chord. Now the chord code for a minor is 0-3-7, whereas the chord code for a major chord is 0-4-7. So in order to go from four to three, we have to drop that one note down one. And that's the difference between a major and a minor chord. And the reason you don't learn as quickly in the traditional music theory path is because they make you memorize scales first. And that's the problem. So we're teaching you a way to bypass scales, use them when you feel like it, get straight to the chord for what it is. And this is why our system is so powerful. Okay, so these are the two main chord types. Now, you've heard the myth that major chords sound happy and minor chords sound dark. And I'm going to break that myth right now for you so that you can be free of the lie. So what we're going to do is take this major chord and we're going to start up. So let's do the C major and then we're going to go to G minor. So it's going to sound quote unquote happy. And then the minor chord is going to sound quote unquote dark. So again, the chord on the left is a major, chord on the right is a minor. Now what happens if we flip these two? So what happens if we play a major chord? Let's flip them. What happens if we play a minor chord and then a major chord? Okay, and then what happens if we go downward? Now doesn't the major chord sound dark now? Isn't that crazy? So let me pull it up an octave just to show you. Isn't that a phenomenon? Just a second ago, the major chord sounded happy going into the minor chord. Now the major chord sounds super dark and it doesn't sound happy at all. It sounds darker than the minor chord. So what you have to break in your mind is the bad teaching of people who are trying to teach you how to memorize stuff to get through stuff. And this is, music theory is very simple. It's just you were taught it in a complicated way. And here's what I'm getting to. What really creates mood is not a type of chord. It's actually the direction of the chord. So once you understand this basic thing, you can create mood a lot easier. So for example, the trick here is that I went from a minor chord down to a major chord, whereas before we went from a major chord down to a minor chord. So let's just prove this theory. Let's copy the same exact chord progression. And this time we're going to go up to a major chord. So the major chord is higher in frequency than the minor chord. So again, in the beginning, it's going to go down. It's going to go from minor chord to major chord. So it's going to sound dark. Then we're going to go from a minor chord up to a major chord. It's going to sound happy. Then we're going to run our experiment to say what happens if the major chord is first and the minor chord is second. So we're going to move this out of the way. And then we're going to pull this over. I know schematically looks chaotic, but I'm giving you the secrets to perception, okay? So now we're gonna go from the major chord down to the minor chord, and then the major chord up to the minor chord, just to prove to you that it's about direction, it's not about a chord type, okay? So our thesis, our hypothesis here says that this should sound dark, this should sound happy, and you know what, I should probably give these different colors, that'll make this easier. What color you guys want for happy? I'll let you guys vote. Think Roy G. Biv, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet. What colors do you want for happy? And then we'll switch the color to happy. And then which one do you want for dark? I think dark would be purple. Maybe, actually, I'm going to make an executive decision here and make dark purple because it looks like the little demon emoji. All right, so we're going to make all the dark stuff purple. Purple, like a dark purple. It's even called dark orchard. Oh, wait, can we not? I thought we could change the individual notes. Why is this stuck? Something on my screen. Hold on, y'all. My screen got stuck. There we go. You said yellow for happy. Y'all didn't even say, you just said yellow. Okay, yellow would be happy. So let's switch this to like a yellow. Why is this changing my whole screen's color? Hold on, I think I screwed this up. I done screwed it up. I done screwed it up. Well, anyway, imagine that, you know what, here's what we're gonna do. Since I screwed it up, we're gonna do this. This is happy. The one that's highlighted is happy. The one that's not highlighted is sad, okay? So going downward, again, this top note D is going down to a G, whereas the top note D here is going up to a G, so it's gonna be happy. This top note is G going down to a D. This top note is G going up to a D. So every time the chords go up, it creates happiness. Let's prove this theory right now. So again, this should be dark. This should be happy. This should be dark. This should be happy. Last one's debatable. This one's debatable. It's kind of like happy, but it still feels a tiny bit sad. But the theory, for the most part, has been ironclad through all my music production technique. So that is the key to writing better chord progressions. It's not the chord type. You were taught that, you know, your chords have to be... How do we go back to default on here? Apply default color. It's not doing it. All right. Hopefully that... We can get our color back. Oh, we're on the wrong thing. Duh. That's why. Okay. Ooh. So if you ever wonder how to get your colors back, hit the little D for default, because you don't want to be picking random colors. Okay. So once you learn that up is happy and down is sad, now your melodies, you'll have an easier time making melodies. You're like, okay, I want this part to be sad. Let's go downward a little bit more. I want this part to be happy. Let's go upward a little bit more. I want my chords to feel darker. Let's go down a little bit more. It's that simple. So now let's get into the keys. So I'll let you vote which one you want to start with. Do you want to start with UK drill, trap, or sample beats? I'll do a little, hold on. You want to do sample beats, you want to do UK drill, or you want to do trap or other? I'll just say other. We'll say like pop or other. Hold on one sec. What type of beats you want to make? Let's do a poll. And then once we get enough votes, then we'll get started. But I had to break those myths, because again, those myths are what hold you back. You're always thinking that the next thing is going to get you this type of mood, or like the next thing is going to give you this type of sound. And no, stock plugins and FL, just don't waste your money buying the FL like stuff. Like, just buy the producer edition, consider it a nice canvas, and buy your sound plugins elsewhere. That way you're going to get closer to the hip hop sound. Also, if you want a bunch of free sounds, I think I linked it in the video description. It's called, go to www.producercommunity.net. And there you can get a bunch of sounds that you need for hip hop. Drum kits and all types of stuff. You said Drake. So I'm going to let everybody in the chat vote. So you have, this is a full on equal democracy. We're going to let you vote. About 150 people in here, so I'll try and get 100 votes. But if not, we'll just wait till the thing says 1 minute, and then we'll start. So in the meantime, I'll play some chords for you. Actually, let's open up Expand, because Expand is pretty cool. So this was $5, but now it's like 15. But still, if you had to spend money on sounds, I would say Expand 2 is going to give you a lot of sounds for a good price. Basically like having a keyboard. You said R&B. So if you want to vote R&B, hit the other button. We're almost at 100 votes. Kind of evenly spread. Trap won by like a hair. I don't know. It's 30% to 24%. So I guess that is a pretty significant gap. But it was pretty close. You guys are pretty spread across the board. You wanted kind of everything. Excuse me. And let me make sure I add pop to this. So, okay. So trap won by like a smidgen. So we just got to go with the votes and be fair to everybody who voted. So let's start with trap. I'll show you how simple trap is in like 3 seconds. We've been making trap so much that it's literally encoded into my finger DNA. So what is trap? Let's first get into what is trap. Trap is a genre created at what's called double time. So instead of producing like 70 BPM, 80 BPM, 90 BPM, we produce at double that number for a reason. So if I turn on the metronome and I hit spacebar, it's very fast. Older hip hop, we produced in like 90 BPM, something like this. I'm not on my Timbo beatboxing mode, but you get what I'm saying. Okay, it's very slow. Nowadays, we pull it up to at least 140. Now, Migos produce at 132. 140 is more like Travis Scott territory. 150 is your melodic guys like, you know, Kid Leroy, you know, Playboi Carti, or anybody melodic, Gunna, Young Thug. And then 170 plus is basically like Tekashi 6ix9ine type people who are very, like Meek Mill, very party like sound. 170 and up to about 180, I've seen even. Okay. So those are your ranges of like tempo. Let's do melodic today. So let's start at 150. This is like the melodic range. Okay. So I'm going to show you how to quickly come up with melodies and make them sound good. So again, first thing, we're going to open up FL keys. The reason we want to write in piano is because piano can easily translate to every other instrument. So even if I didn't want a piano sound, I could just copy the MIDI and paste it into a different sound. How about Migos? I would do Migos, but their beats are very, it's literally like two notes. And it's just not, you know, I'm not going to make you come here to learn how to play two notes. And shout out to the Migos. I mean, they're good. It's just their music is not musical in the fact that there's not a lot of chord changes, which is fine. That's just how they, anyway. Let's right click. Let's open up FL keys. Let's go to presets and we're going to go down to where it says dance piano. Okay. So again, in this video, I'm going to show you how to make that like melodic trap type of sound. Let's right click. Let's go to piano roll. I'm going to show you so many shortcuts that are going to save you time. And we've gone over these many times, but again, masters know that they have to master the basics over and over and over again. You know how many trap beat tutorials I had to make for trap beats to be like make them in the blink of an eye? I had to make hundreds in order to embed it into my brain to know how to make trap beats in with my eyes closed. Oh yeah, poly sounds. Yeah, I don't want to confuse people. So the first thing we're going to do is figure out a chord type. So I'm going to show you shortcuts again. In FL Studio, at least, there's something called a chord stamp. So this saves you time memorizing the chord codes. But you should know chord codes because you want to problem solve as you go. We don't want to get too complicated. But you can go to the little chord stamp right here and select a minor seventh chord. We're just going to drag this in anywhere. Doesn't really matter where we start. Hit control up to move this up an octave. And again, we're making melodic trap. So again, what makes a minor seventh chord? There's a chord code to it. And this is what you can get for free at busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. The link should be in the video description. So again, I can double check this. Okay, a minor seventh chord is 0, 3, 7, 10. So I start here at the bottom note. This is considered zero. And I just count up the keyboard. So it's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, 10, 0, 3, 7, 10 always makes a minor 7 chord no matter what. Okay, so minor 7ths are going to be your general starting point because they give you enough notes to play around with. You could do triads or 3-note chords, but again, it's a different type of sound. So all we're really listening to is this top note. So when you listen to this chord, you're really only listening to the top note of the chord. And your brain probably didn't realize that until I pointed it out. So when you're going through chord progressions, I can just put one note, and this is the power of chord codes as well. I can draw out one note. So I'm gonna do it. So whenever you have trouble with timing, turn on the metronome. And I can come up with chords, even though this is one note, I can actually expand it into different chord types. And this is why I showed you all those preliminary things, because now I say, okay, I'm just gonna assume this chord type is a minor seven chord type. Okay, so we're gonna copy that over, delete the top note so it doesn't stack up on notes. And then I can say, does that sound good or does it sound bad? It sounds fine. We're going to copy the same minor seventh over here. Delete that top note because it overlaps. Now, luckily, these all sound good as minor. But let's say you didn't like the minor sound and you wanted it to sound major. You would take the bottom note and the middle note, in this case, the fifth. Okay? And you would pull these down. You would highlight these notes and you would hit shift down to transpose those into major. So now these are major seventh chords. Switch them back to minor, hit shift up. Okay, Okay, we're going to swap out the sound, but I just wanted to start with piano because this is easy for people to hear. No, I don't want to confuse people again with the higher extensions. A minor ninth is 0, 3, 7, 10, 14. So those are on the chord code charts. And a major nine is 0, 4, 7, 11, 14. So they both have that 14 number in there. So now once we have these chords, now we can say, okay, now that I've accounted for the top note that I'm listening to, let's add bottom notes. So what I'm showing you here is how to get your beat to bounce before you even add the drums. This is the point of this section. So now we're going to create the bass drum, so to speak, of the chord progression, which is the lower notes. So here's where you can get pretty creative and jazzier, more jazzy. So I'm going to go dun, dun, dun. Then I'm going to go dun, bun, bun. So let's copy these same chords. Now, chances are we're not going to use the same chords, but let's copy them over. Now, this piano is very boisterous, so let me actually switch it to the normal piano because it's playing the keys so hard that you can't hear the harmony. There we go. And I'll show you a technique to make this sound. We're getting there, step by step. Just so right here, now I'm trying to work from the bottom up. Instead of the top down, we're working from the bottom up. Now this gets a little complicated because these notes are technically inside of the chord. So these are actually the fourths of the chord. And if you pull them up, they're actually the 11th. And I don't want to go too advanced. This is why I said, we're teaching you simple stuff, but it can go so deep because these are actually 11ths that we're playing as the bass. So let's pull this back. Okay, so let's turn these off for now. Actually, I'm trying to think, how can we apply this? So let's copy the same formula for the first one. So I know I'm moving a little bit quicker here, but this is kind of arbitrary. Let's pull this up. So what I'm doing is matching the pattern from the left to the right. So the bass here was the top note of our chord here. Okay, so I'm making sure that the bass here, top note of the chord here. Now the second bass note was actually what's called the 11th of the next chord. So in order to get there, we have to structure this like an 11th chord. And this is where it gets visually complicated, but in reality, it's not that complicated. So we need to pull this up. And we need to make sure that this D sharp is the 11th of some chord. Now, how do you create an 11th? We have chord codes that map this out. So in order to get to an 11th without boring you to tears is 0, 4, 7, 11, 14, 21 is the next number. So this has to be 21. And then we're counting down. So it's 21, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14. So now the next note in here should be 14. So let's pull this down. Wait, I lost count that quick. 20, 19, 18, 17. Wait, 20. 19, 18, 17, 16. 15, 14, so it's G sharp should be the top note here. Okay, and then this should harmonize better. Okay, so it sounds quote unquote right. But what we're doing from this point is we're taking this what's called add 11 or the 11th and we're pulling it down two octaves, actually three octaves. So I hit control down three times. Okay, so that's how you get these really expanded sounds using chords. And most people overlook chords because they think chords are just for like playing straight out like this. And that's not the case. So yeah, I am getting a little advanced, but I'm showing people the power of chord codes for those who are skeptical. And lastly, again, I'm showing you how to build a chord from one note. That's what I'm showing you, basically. So we did get a little advanced. So this note, again, I'm going to pull it up 1, 2, 3 octaves. We're going to assume that this is the 11th of some chord, and then we're going to count down using chord codes. So again, a chord code, if you had to visually see what a chord code looked like, it would look like this. This would be what it looked like. So all I'm doing is saying, since I played this three octaves down, how do I map the rest of the chord out to actually match this? Now, technically, the chord that we're making does not have what's called the ninth in there, so it's going to look like this. So all I'm doing is moving the notes to match what's over here. So that's what I'm doing, for those who are wondering. And then we pull that note from up here down, one, two, three octaves. So we created really lush chords using two different octaves. Most people think that when you build chords that you have to play them straight out, like this. They think you have to play an 11th chord straight out like this. But sometimes you could play a D minor 7 chord and then play the 11th in the bass, for example. So my fingers can't stretch like they want to. Hold on one sec, let's do. So we're still harmonizing the chord, but it gives us a cool bass line. So for people who struggle with bass lines, this is why you have to learn chords. And this is why I have all this training at busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. I break it down into bite-sized chunks so that you can understand what you're doing and how to increase your bass lines, how to make them sound more musical. Now this one, I want to go. I actually want the same chord type because now my ear likes this chord type. I'm going to copy that chord. Yeah, this is called chord voicing, for those who are wondering for the technical term. And I'll show you how to trapify it. We're not there yet. Okay, so now that we have the chord types, we can hit Control L to drag these chords out. And now we can get into those other sounds that we talked about. Now before we get to the other sounds, let's highlight these top notes. Hit Control Select, or Control, Shift, I meant to say. Highlight these top notes. We're going to go to where it says, Tools. We're going to go to Chop. And you could change it into any time multiplier you want. So I could do it fast like this. And one thing we learned in the Advanced Music Theory Masterclass that we have with Travis Marsh, who plays 12 instruments plus, we learned that melody is also rhythm. And a lot of us forget that, like, rhythm is a frequency. Same way BPM is, that's actually a frequency. The same way if I play a note on the piano, that's just a higher frequency. But this is a frequency too. So we forget that frequency is melody. So sometimes just playing a note three times is melody. Because he played like Happy Birthday or... Wait, what did he play? Basically, he played one note and he was like this. He just played one note and he was like, what song is that? And I said, oh, that's the Happy Birthday song. He was like, yeah, but I didn't play any notes. I just played one note. So the point is that rhythm is just as important in a melody as the notes. It's the rhythm that we're used to. So we're going to chop this up into rhythm. And a lot of us forget about that part. So the cool part about this is once you chop up these top notes, you can now use the music theory knowledge of intervals and chord expansions to make this sound cooler. So I could do what's called a fifth. And this is, I know I'm moving a little bit quickly here, but I don't want to harp on too much stuff because then we can get too deep down the rabbit hole. But again, really the main lesson is that there's two chord types, major and minor chord types. And that's all you really need to know. But chords make up melody. Chords make up bass. You have to understand chords because chords are what makes stuff sound good together. Okay, so chords are really the foundation. So now what we're going to do is add what are called perfect fifths and perfect fourths. One, two, three, four, five. So perfect fourth is five semitones up. So all I'm doing is displacing this note. One, two, three, four, five semitones. Now this one sounds weird being up there. So again, here's another kind of caveat. I know I'm giving you little gems here and there because I don't want to go too deep. The fourths are great for tension. Okay, so fourths are ways to continue the music. It creates tension. So if I go from, this is C major, C, E, G. It sounds complete because it has a tonic and a fifth in it. What's up, Sarab? So what happens if I don't go up to the fifth? I just go. See how, like, when I land on what's called the fifth, it ends the feeling. But if I keep using that fourth, then once we get to the fifth, it's just like complete. It's harmonized. It's complete. It feels completed, resolved, so to speak. So fourths are great for keeping things moving musically, because a lot of people are like, how do you create transitions in your beats? And sometimes it's based in the music that you actually use. You shouldn't even have to have drums and all this to have your stuff transition. So now let's create a more realistic sound. We're going to swap this out and replace it for a different sound. Let's do, I'm trying to think, what is FL's? I was messing with Silent the other day. I mean, not Silent, Citrus the other day. Let's go to Citrus, let's go to Presets, and let's go to like Chromatic Marimba. See how it gives, just by swapping out the sound. So we don't need every single hit. Now that we have that, let me show you a couple more shortcuts you want to learn. Alt R. This is great for piano stuff or like any live instrument type sound. It doesn't really apply to the image line stuff or the stuff that comes stock with FL because their sensitivity for velocity is very different. Long story short, if you hit Alt R, turn off this pattern mode so it doesn't look chaotic like this. Go to levels and mess with the velocity tab. This will randomize the velocity so it feels like you're actually playing like a human. Humans don't play. We don't play the same velocity every single time we play. It's different every single time. That's what creates the human feel to it. So we're going to go to levels, turn up velocity, hit accept. Now let's say that's too harsh. You can hit Alt X and pull down what's called the multiply to soften the sound. For most plugins, this softens the sound. I don't want to get into modes today because it's really not beat making. That's more music theory. But we do cover that in our premium section. Just go to premium.busyworksbeats.com. Let's hit accept. Another one you want to learn is Alt S in FL Studio. Mess with the strength tool. It creates a brum sound. It just makes it sound more bouncy and alive. I'm going to keep it. I know it's a little exaggerated, but let's keep it that way. And then you have to grab the slice tool and slice off the end. Yeah, so those shortcuts you want to know about. Those are the shortcuts. So for example, let's swap out the sound. Just to show you how music overrides everything, now we can go through and swap out the sound and just pick a vibe. Thank you, Able Beats. Just learn something. Able Beats is the king of very musical music. Let's go to brass. Pretty thick brass here we got. Let's try pulling this up one octave. So to pull stuff up an octave, hit Control Up or Command Up on Mac. I kind of like this for like a Playboy Cardi sound, so we might use this. Also, I just thought of another trick that you guys need to learn about. Go to your cog icon, go to your wrench tool, turn on what's called portamento mode, and turn this slide amount up. So now when you play chords, it's a little hard to hear, hold on. It goes like, wang, wang. I'll exaggerate it so you can really hear. You hear the notes going, wow, wow. That's how you get the Playboy Cardi sound. Okay, so try portamento. That's going to add that like EDM-esque sound. Now these chords move so much. Portamento is better for chords that don't move. Like since we're doing all this, it's gonna sound too wobbly, but this is good for when your chords are pretty static. So Let's hear what it sounds like, but I'm probably not going to use as much portamento because there's a lot of movement. Let's also try pulling this up one octave, control up. It's a little thick of a sound. Let's keep going through sounds. I mean, I like the tone, but it's a little thick. So let's keep going through presets. But once you have the music, you're pretty much set. That's super harsh. That's why I said these sounds aren't really made for hip hop. Let's try more chromatic. Let's try like bell stuff. That's a little too chill, too vibey. This is kind of cool. Let's use this for example. Now I'm going to take it up to a whole different level. Now you guys voted for trap for this beat. So trap is pretty much, once you learn the rhythms, you're pretty much set. But again, you have to have the right sounds. That's the hard problem. Getting those sounds, okay? So let's add this in to the playlist. So we're going to the playlist mode here, which is right here. Grabbing the pattern, just left click, drag it in. And then I keep my snap to grid to one bar so everything lines up. And then you just copy it or hit control B to latch paste. So it copies all the way through. Now we're not done with the processing yet. So here's where we turn regular sounds into what we call trap sounds. So let's right click. Let's go to consolidate from this track, from track start. Now this may or may not crash FL, so I'm gonna save it first. Okay, right click, consolidate this track from track start, and hit start. Okay, so now we have the what's called MIDI, or the notes that we play on the piano. The notes that we have on the notes that we're playing on piano were turned into audio. So like a sample, we've created a sample for ourselves. So if I go to the top left, I can go to channel settings. I like to switch my mode to stretch mode. So no matter what the BPM, it will keep its same pitch and it will sound the same no matter the BPM. But what we can do is we can pitch it up an octave. So let's mess with it going up an octave, which is 1200 cents. We can pull it down an octave or negative 1200 cents. We could reverse it. We could do a lot of things. Click on reverse. So if you wanted to do a reverse section, we could time stretch it. So if you go to the top left where it says audio clips, go to stretch mode. You can grab this side and drag it to double the length. Make it slower. And here's where you can go back to your channel effects, start pulling down the effects. You can reverse it. Not bad. If you need, remember the replay will be here. You could always pause it. I'm just showing you how to manipulate your melodies. That's what trap is all about. It's more than just the notes we play. It's the effects we add to the actual sound. So we can go down that whole area of sound later, but I just wanted to show you that's how we get to that. So now I like the brass sound. So I'm actually going to go back to the brass, and I think it was called Greasy something. Okay, so now we're going to get into making this sound like a Playboi Carti type sound. So now it's all about the sounds. If you don't have these sounds, it's going to be very, very hard to get the trap sound if you're using the wrong sounds. Okay, so this is why I said FL is a great canvas, but they don't necessarily give you the sounds that you need to make your genre, which is fine. So I have under my friends folder, and I sent this out to everybody who was on our email list. So if you aren't on it, you missed it. But these are called the Essential 808s. Basically, what's called a Roland TR-808 clap has been in hip hop since you name it. I don't even know what year that started, but we still use it today. You're gonna hear this clap everywhere. This is how we do to make a move in that the fool. I be up in the club. This we've been using it since like a gazillion years ago. Okay, so then you want to grab an 808 that you like. Most people like the Spins 808 for tone. So if you're going to play a lot of notes with your 808, right click, open that up in new channel. If you're going to play a lot of like melodic notes where your 808's doing a lot of dancing around like that, we usually go for Spins 808 if you're going to be tonal with your 808. But if you're just going to, you want an 808 that just knocks, you can go for the Zaytoven 808, which looks like this. Some people call it the baby 808. I call it the TikTok 808. So we're not really being musical with this 808. Is my stream messed up? Hold on, let me check the stream. No, we're still good. It says we're good on my end. So the 808 TikTok, the TikTok 808 is not as tonal. So we just play one note. We don't play a bunch of notes most of the time. So those are the main differences. The baby 808, I probably should call it something else now that he's all in hot water right now. But the TikTok 808, we usually only play one note. We use it like a kick drum. The Spins 808, we play a lot of different notes with the 808. Okay, it's more of a tonal thing. So those are your two main 808s for trap. You got the Spins 808. The Zaytoven 808. I call it the TikTok 808. That's it. Everybody else just stole from the Spins 808. I hate to be telling you Santa Claus doesn't exist, but the Murder 808 is a Spins 808. I know you signed, not this 808, but there's another Murder. Let me show you. The Murder Beats. Shout out the Murder Beats. This is not shade towards Murder Beats either. I just want to show you that everybody uses the same sounds. This sound right here. I know you probably can't hear it if it's too low. Is the Zaytoven 808 that I just showed you. The same sound. Look, I'm playing the same note. Literally the same sound. And this is no shade. This is just in his collection of sounds. And there's another one that he used that's like the same sound. So I just want y'all to know that the core 808s, Zaytoven's 808, Spins 808. Once you know that, you will stop searching for all these other 808s, okay? And trap also has like this scratchy snare sound that they got from Kanye. So let me show you what that looks like in our Ultimate Producer Bundle. It's called Snare Ham. So it's this sound right here. And without giving you a whole history, this basically came from an old drum machine and it was made to be super loud. But it's basically from an old drum machine. So you're going to hear this like Waka Flocka type Kanye, Travis Scott type snare. So that's the snare right there. Okay. And then you have this clap. Those are the two main snares and claps you're going to hear that you're going to hear in trap. And then here's your two main 808s. One is tonal that you can play a lot of notes. I guess the chat can help you find these sounds, but I gave you the main names. It's Zaytoven 808. You could probably Google that. Spins 808. You could probably Google that. Roland TR 808 clap. You could probably Google that. And then the snare. I don't know what the snare would be called, but it's in our Ultimate Producer Bundle. Okay. So that's where that snare comes from. So those are your main ingredients. Like I said, we can make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich and try to make it into a Chick-fil-A sandwich, or we could take chicken in a bun and try to make a Chick-fil-A sandwich with that, as opposed to trying to transform sounds that aren't even closely related. So those are the keys. Now your hi-hats are going to be nice and short and simple. Where is it at? 808s. So this is going to be the sound of your hi-hat most of the time for trap. And I'm giving you ear training so that you don't waste time trying to find any other sound that doesn't sound like this. Yeah, the chat can help you guys find the actual drums. But it's nice, short, straight to the point hi-hat. It should look like this, like a little triangle. Very short. Okay, so you're not going to use the long hi-hats. Like, this is not your hi-hat for... I can't say not, because that's not technically true. But let me go to like a stock sound just to show you the sounds that are not for a trap. So for example, if I go here, that is not a trap hi-hat. Neither is that. Neither is that. That isn't either. Neither is that. See how it's very, it's a lot going on, whereas trap is actually like this. This other one has all the stuff going on. So you got to be careful the sounds you use, because that can easily take people out of what we call the trap genre. Now, when you get more advanced, you could switch up the sounds, but for now, start with the ingredients and then you could switch it up later. So those are the sounds that we use for trap. So once you learn the sounds, now we're going to go to a new pattern. So again, your habit should be highlight all your sounds, hit Control L, send them to the mixer. It's going to be auto named. Now we're going to go to pattern 2 in the playlist. Let's close out the browser. We're going to go to patterns mode, grab this pattern, drag it in, and we're going to drag this somewhere around 4 bars or so. And now what we can do is when we actually create in the channel rack, this area here, it will show up in our playlist here. So we can create the beat as we're listening to the musical instruments. And it's really easy to make beats this way. So in the beginning, the first step you should do is turn on the metronome. Remember, we're at 150 BPM. This is in your melodic trap range. If you want Amigo's range, you want to go down to about 130, 132 BPM. If you want Travis Scott, you want to stay around 140 to 144. 144 is where UK drill starts. That's the drill tempo. 150 is where we get into melodic trap. And 170 plus is where we get into like Tekashi 6ix9ine, Meek Mill type club, very aggressive type sound. Okay, so those are the BPMs you need to know. So let's go to pattern mode and let's start mapping out this stuff. So the first thing you need to know about the rhythms is turn your metronome on. And we're just doing trap right now. We're going to get into the other genres in a second, because you guys voted for trap at 34%. And then we'll get into sample beats, and then we'll get into UK drill and then pop. Okay, so the main thing is where you put your clap or your snare. So typically people they get in the habit of putting their snare on these little red spots. But remember, we're not at regular tempo, we're at double tempo. So technically the snare should wait. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So basically if you listen to the metronome and count, just count to 3 and count to 7. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it's on the 3 and the 7 count. So again, listen to this sound and then it should hit on the 3 and the 7. What's up, Nafi Beats? So it hits on the 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that's how you count out music. And that's going to be your main structure of how you map out your trap drums. So I'm giving you the core rhythms, the core sounds, the core chords that you need to know to make this type of music. And I'm proving it by making it right in front of your face. That sounded weird. Right in front of your face? That sounded kind of weird. Let's use our TikTok 808. And now we're going to create rhythms. But again, with the TikTok 808, it doesn't need to be like all over the place like a bass line. We're just using it like a kick drum. So we're just going to, the main rhythm I love is boom, 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 boom. Once you learn that rhythm, you realize we use it in everything. That's the basic rhythm. So get used to this rhythm. I'm going to let it loop a little bit so you get it in your brain. Boom, 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 boom. Okay, so these are all core rhythms. So I let that get into your subconscious mind, because that's the core rhythm behind everything. It's boom, 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 boom. Now, of course, they change it up over time. So I'm going to show you the hacks to get different styles of artistry. So if you're going for Travis Scott doesn't use as much. And I can't say doesn't, because I don't want to say always or never. But the key to the Travis Scott sound is, instead of using the boom, 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 that's a very dancey bounce. He'll take out the in-between 808s. So Travis Scott, if you wanted to make this more Travis Scott, you would take out 808 2 and 3. So it'd be like boom, 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 boom. Okay, you would just take out these bouncy 808s right here. And it's that infinite gap, that space that creates the Travis Scott sound. So here's what I'll do. I'll make one pattern that's like, I'll call this like Playboy Cardi, I guess, or some kind of like dancier rapper. Let's rename this. Let's rename this like Playboy Cardi. That's his bounce. Then we'll make this one unique over here. Click up here, gonna make unique. Let's rename this Travis Scott. Just to show you how it's the rhythm. Oh, what's up, Chris? My mentor, Christopher Moye. Thank you for hopping on in. I was trying to correspond with you and pay attention at the same time, but he's taught me a lot about the new world of music. So I have some really cool news for you guys when it's all made public. A lot of cool stuff. So what I'm going to do here for the Travis Scott rhythm is, again, the rhythm goes boom, 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 boom. Instead of that, we're going to get rid of these bouncy 808s, that second and third 808. So it creates a gap. So keep in mind, gaps are just as important as the notes. So now we're going to go from a Playboy Cardi type bounce to a Travis Scott bounce. And then I'll show you how to get to a, I'm trying to think of an artist who uses this other, like a Gunna bounce. And then we'll level and make the beat sound good. Again, we're using stock sounds right now, so they're not the greatest. Notice those gaps in the Travis Scott. Let me run that back because I talked all over this. So I want you to listen to the activity of the 808 for the Playboy Cardi rhythm, and then the difference in the Travis Scott. Notice how the gaps become the instrument in the Travis Scott. Now we're going to get into another type of rhythm. Let's call this, let's make this unique firstly. Let's rename this. Let's call this like Gunna. So the only difference that they do in this style is they do back-to-back 808s. So instead of boom, 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 they'll do like boom, 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 boom. They'll do like double 808s. So again, I'm showing you the little nuances that give you the whole genre. So it's boom, 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 boom. Okay, so it's double 808s. Thank you, Chris. So these double 808s create like a Meek Mill type Gunna type sound. It's something about that stutter effect. And then I'll show you Chicago Drill. So I didn't realize there's so much to show you guys. Let's make this last one unique. And let's rename this Chicago Drill. Chicago Drill. And when we get into drill, it'll all make sense. So I'm kind of giving you the precursors and the DNA of all these different genres so you can mix and match them the way you want. And then we'll get into actual beat making with the sounds that I would actually use, because I wouldn't use these stock sounds, but I'm just showing you how to do it. Anyway, let's go to Chicago Drill. Now this is the last drum pattern I'm going to show you. Now this one, the key is that you're putting the 808s on the snare. So it's like boom, 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 boom. The kick and the snare overlap. So let me show you what that sounds like. So shout out to Young Chop for creating this sound. Oops, I thought they were lined up. They visually weren't lined up. So the kick and the snare, boom, boom, boom at the end. You'll see that a lot in drill. So we have all four main categories of hip hop just by simply moving the 808 around. That's why I said, when you study the basics, you'll become a lot better, because again, it's not about learning something new all the time. Sometimes it's understanding that every color is red, yellow, and blue. Every color is red, yellow, and blue. So if every color is red, yellow, and blue, I could take this phone and figure out the formula for this specific color by decoding it into red, yellow, and blue. What percentage of each? And so you start to see things for what they are. Anyway, so Playboy Cardi rhythm, Travis Scott rhythm, Gunna rhythm, and then the Chicago Drill using the same exact sounds. So again, for those who are new here, just listen to the 808 timing. If you can't hear it, I'll try to spice up the 808 a little bit more. Can you guys hear the 808? I just need a yes or no real quick. Is the 808 audible on your mobile? If not, I'll run it through a certain plugin to kind of give it more harmonics, they're called. It's like the Karate Kid picking up the jacket 100 times. Exactly. Like, I can teach you how to punch. Can't hear the 808? Okay, I'll... Some people hear it, some people don't. So what I'll do is I'll pull up my favorite plugin. This is not a beginner plugin by any means. This thing is probably like $300. So don't stress about this plugin. It's just the one I use. You can use any saturator plugin. I'm just using this one to turn up the 808. So you should be able to hear it now. It should be audible. So again, I'm just doing this so you could hear it. So again, first pattern is a Playboi Carti pattern. Second one is Travis Scott. Third one is Gunna. And then the last one is a Chicago drill. So again, just listen to the 808 timing. Then we'll get into all the other stuff about genre. Actually, this 808 is a little... I might use the Spins 808 because this one... So here's another shortcut. If you want to quickly edit stuff, highlight it, hit Control G. That will make one big pattern with it. You just double click, go inside. For example, I want to swap out the 808. So I'm going to hit Command X or Control X on PC. Hit Control V to paste. And now we're on the Spins 808 as opposed to the TikTok 808. I'm going to... It's because this one has a little more tone. There we go. So you should be able to hear it on phones. Oh, now the patterns aren't the same. So now everything looks different. I didn't even realize I did that. So again, it goes Playboi Carti, Travis Scott, Gunna, Chicago drill. Then we'll move into the hi-hat rhythms, and then we'll move into UK drill, and then we'll move into sample hip-hop, and then we'll move into pop production. But this is the core foundation of trap. Okay, so the last step here is hi-hats, and I'll be really quick about this because we spend a lot of time just on those basic principles. So again, the hi-hat sound is this. Very short, straight to the point. All you gotta do is just right click, fill each two steps. That's it. This is the most basic. Even Travis Scott, even Drake uses this rhythm. This is not something that is so basic that the top guys don't use it. And again, for those who just joined, this is a masterclass on how to make beats. We train over 700,000 producers around the world. Some have gone to work with Drake, Young Thug, Post Malone, YG, Ray Shremmerd, French Montana, NBA Youngboy, Ariana Grande. So this stuff works on a high level. They use it for their Billboard charting artists. And it's this simple. That's really how simple the hi-hats are. Now I'm going to show you one trick. I know I'm getting too in the weeds about little stuff, but if you click on the 808, go to the wrench tool, turn up what's called time shift. This will delay the 808 a little to the right so it doesn't sound so quantized and locked onto the grid. You can do the same thing with your hi-hats if they sound too like... This is the Metro Boomin technique. Now the drums sound a little more spacey. They feel like they have a lot more space. Oops. A lot more space. Let's go back. So everything doesn't need to be loud. Let's turn down the hi-hats. Now the quickest hi-hat roll you could do is just adding a hi-hat in the step sequencer. So like... Okay, another way to add hi-hat rolls is right click, go to piano roll, and find a space where you want to add a hi-hat roll. So it's like tit 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 brr. So right here I want a hi-hat roll. I'm just gonna add in a note and highlight the note, hit Alt A. I learned this from Chop Squad DJ. Then change your time multiplier. Okay, to whatever you want. Keep the range on one and change your time multiplier. So this will chop up that note into multiple notes, and it's a quick way to create hi-hat rolls. Hit accept. Now, if the note's too loud, you could hit shift, left click, and then make a linear change to the velocity. If you don't see this at the bottom, you want to click on these little ellipses, left click and pull this up until you see the velocity. Then you just make the hi-hat rolls wherever you want. So now we have two hi-hat patterns going on. So I just changed the note for the 808. Now again and again. On and on and on. We can go back and we could change out the sound. So if you don't like that sound, you could always change it back to the FL keys. And again, from here, you could do 1,000 things. You could take out parts in the piano. You know, there's a gazillion things you could do from here. Like, we don't need to have these repeat, for example. So here's a little hidden rule that I found for myself. You can do things in threes. So for example, notice how I'm doing three things. That was kind of sounded cool, but it was a little loud. So let me turn this down a little bit. So I'm playing three chords. Then I repeat one, two, three. So you can use that rule for your chord progressions and your melodies. If your melody gets too convoluted or too confusing, knock it down to three things. So one, two, three. One, two, three. Okay, so if it ever gets too confusing, you could do that. So this one has a lot of stuff going on. So I would move this note over, for example. And I would get rid of this last chord. So if it gets too complicated, that's what I would do to make this sound more minimal. Because the other one sounds too like up and down and up and down. So I'm just giving you the keys on how to kind of structure this stuff. Let's figure out a chord progression. What did I say? So I know the 808's out of key right now, but I just want to show you this is how the NBA YoungBoy type beats are made. If you're going for this kind of sad melodic sound. Then I'll show you how to add melody on top of this. So again, threes. One, two, three. One, two, three. Keyscape. No, this is FL keys. I'm just playing on really high velocity. That's why it has that sound. Okay, so now let's go back. I'm gonna change the 808, so don't worry about the actual tone right now. I'm playing three chords, and I'll show you what those chords are. One, two. Play the wrong chord, but it is what it is. I don't know why I played the wrong chord twice. I even called myself editing myself. Okay, so here's the chords for those who like the sound, for example. Let's hit Alt Q to quantize. And again, we need to change up the 808 note because it's out of key. I don't want to get too deep into keys and how to tune right now. It's too much. So we need the 808 to go. Right now, let's take out the 808 because it's confusing the ear. So let's fix this last chord. This is the chord type I'm meant to play. Edit this, slide this thing over here. Okay, so it's one, two, three. It's the rule of threes. We use this in art, we use it in music, we use it in photography. A good photographer knows to keep room ahead. Like most people, when they take a picture, their head's at the top of the frame and then their feet are at the bottom of the frame. Good photographers, when they take a picture, your head isn't all the way at the top of the frame. It's actually space above your head in a third of the picture. So it's a third of the space above your head to your torso, and then your torso to your feet. So everything's in threes. Even the Mona Lisa, I think, is in threes, something like this. So it's called the rule of threes. We use it for songwriting. We use it for hook writing. We use it for beat making. It's just something that we just use. So you could do this, and then it's common technique is right click clone this and then use the second piano to write the top line melody. Let's go to piano roll. I'll show you what you need to have on. If you go to the top left, let's go to helpers. Let's turn on what's called ghost channels, because if I turn that off, all those gray notes go away. And the reason we want those gray notes is because we want to see what we played in our chord so that we can kind of stay in the same ballpark. So now I can add top line or higher frequency melody that goes throughout this chord. So instead of just playing chords, I can now play, you know, whatever the notes are. So let's just add in some notes. So the question would be, where do you start? Easy place to start is the top note of the chord. And then pull it up one octave or hit control up. So now I'm just gonna use my brain to tell me what notes sound good. So you could make this scientific, and I could make myself sound smarter by telling you that this is a minor third, and this is the fifth of G and all this. I could tell you all this, but really I'm just listening to my brain tell me what note I want. So I'm gonna go. Okay, now right here, I want it to kind of go ring, ding, ding, ding. Okay, I know I'm not making a lot of sense, but I call it a slide note. In Italian, I think they call it a glissando. We're not speaking Italian, so we don't call it that. So we're gonna highlight this note and then hit Alt and left click and drag it a little to the right. So now the notes go. Instead of very computerized, robotic, we go. So that's how you get that NBA Youngboy type sound. And then I'll show you a master key. So we're not done yet, but we're almost there. So I want to go dun, 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 boom. Oops, gotta get the timing right. Now I'm gonna go. So we're gonna copy this over, hit control to highlight, hit shift, left click and drag it over. But now I wanna go. So don't be afraid to whistle it out. I used to do that at 2 a.m. and I know it made my mom upset because I would be whistling the melody until I got the notes right. So this is how you start thinking through your melodies. It starts with chords, and that's why I wanted to show you the chord stuff first. MIDI keyboard, yeah, I would recommend a MIDI keyboard. It just, clicking notes, it can be overly confusing. Now I'm gonna go. Then I go dun, dun, dun. So notice, I'll show you in a second because I don't want to cut myself, my brain off. So notice we have a recurring rhythm. So it goes dun, 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 dun. Da-da-da-da. These are really repeating rhythms. These are called motifs. And remember when I told you that melody is also rhythm? I told you that a while ago when I said, what was the? So what's the song I'm playing? Wait, hold on. I'm playing the Happy Birthday song. So Happy Birthday is not only the notes of Happy Birthday, it's the rhythm of Happy Birthday. So a motif is a collection of rhythms that is a melody. Remember, rhythm is melody. So even though we're changing the notes up, we contain the same rhythm. So this is a melodic motif. It's something that is a part of the DNA of the melody that repeats itself. So it goes motif one, then it repeats itself. Then it creates a change on the third thing. Just remember the rule of three. We usually create a change on that third thing. And then we go into the rule of three at the end, playing only three notes. Now, there's no hard rule. I'm just showing you why this sounds good. So it'd be like,
I need too much and need some problems I ain't never had. Please don't do nothing for some problems.
Oh, let me show you now that we're here, actually. One thing you want to do is test your melody to make sure you left enough space for the artist. So now the question becomes, how do we add vocals to this? How do we know if it's a major key, a minor key? There's a plugin called Scalar, or if you don't have this plugin, you can actually go to your phone apps, and there's an app called Piano. So on Piano, what this does is, I'll show you the Piano app first before I show you the, so here's Piano. I don't even know if you can see, I don't even know if y'all can see this. You probably can't, but anyway, it's a piano app on my phone, and I can play different notes. I'll turn my phone up a little bit. We're in the wrong octave. We're in octave like 7 right now. Okay, so all I'm going to do now is play the notes that sound good as I listen to the beat. Let me turn the beat down a little bit. Okay, so now I'm going to play notes on the piano app, and I'm going to figure out which notes sound good with the beat. So we have F. So as I'm playing the notes that sound good, it's prudent to mark them. So let's go into our piano roll. You don't need Scalar for this. I'm just showing you in this blank piano roll. So that's a dark sound. Let's pick a different sound. Hold on, y'all. So F sounds good with this beat. F sounds good. E sounds good. D sounds good. C sounds good. G sounds good. A sounds good. B sounds good. So it's all the white notes, okay? Now, once you map out all the notes that sound good with your beat, now you can go to your tuning plugins, like an Auto Tune or a Waves Tune, and now you can add this in. So let's go to Waves Tune, for example. I'm gonna add this on my voice. If you wanted to test like an NBA Youngboy type melody over this track. And what I'm gonna do is give you a realistic thing. So let me load up a reverb. You don't have to do all this. This is only for the video's sake because we're live. So let's do a little reverb just to give you an idea what it would sound like as the end product. And then he might have like delay or something like this. So Fruity Delay 3, where you at? Fruity Delay 3, where is it? Fruity Delay 3, here we go. Let's do ping pong mode. I know I'm moving a little quickly here, but again, this is only a reference. This is not a must. I'm just setting this up so that we can hear effects.
Effects. Effects.
Check.
Check. Check. Check.
Okay, so now my voice is going through a reverb, and it's going through delay. So that's just stuff for the side. Okay, so what we do is we go to our plugin of choice, and then you just remove the notes that we're not using. So this plugin, to remove notes, you have to click on the note until it has an X over it. And then that's how you remove the notes. So we're just removing all the black notes. So now this auto-tune will lock me in to only the white notes. Thank you, Nicholas DeRosa, for the super chat. So now when I turn my retune speed on 0 and then my note transition down to 0, when I talk, I'm going to be locked into the key, regardless of if you know what the key's name is or not. So now I can act like I'm NBA Youngboy and give you that performance. So I'd be like,
I never dreamed of it.
Wait, let me turn me down because I don't have his tone fully. Turn the piano up.
I never dreamed of had nothing, I was starting off. Even things were patient, they was on a yacht. We talking 30 reasons, nerds when they talking junk. Ain't no running with the sonnets, I swear to God. People just acting like they fakers, they be acting low. I'm telling you, it is like a low. We talking 30.
So you get the idea. I know I don't sound like NBA Youngboy, but always check the key of the song and make sure that there's a pocket for the artist if you can. If you don't have a mic, that's fine, but at least rap in your head or sing in your head, because the biggest thing we producers do is we make these grooves that are unperformable, and you could tell because the kick drum might be in a weird spot or the hi-hats might be in a weird spot. Okay, so that's that. I think we covered everything as far as trap. Pretty sure we covered almost everything as far as trap. So let's move into I'm going to move faster because we're at the hour mark now. So now I'm going to get a little bit faster because we went over the basics of this stuff. So now let's move into UK drill. And let's start anew. So give me a Hold on, I think we got a loop. All right, sometimes my audio trips out. Okay, so now for this one, we are going to do UK drill. And again, I'm going to go a lot quicker here because now you know all the core fundamental basics. Shout out to DJ Wraith for the super chat. Call this masterclass. See what he says. Thank you for all the gems. We love you and appreciate all you do for us. And thank you for all the love you show me. Thank you, DJ Wraith. And we'll be going live at 9. So I got to definitely wrap this masterclass up by 9 because then we got to go live to play your music tonight at 9 p.m. Eastern. So UK drill is a little bit, the only difference is the hi-hat pattern and the snare pattern. But again, it comes down to those core things. So now I'm showing you stuff that isn't stock sounds in FL. So here's where we're getting a little more advanced. So I'm going to do UK drill right now. Then we're going to move into sample beats because that's pretty advanced too. And then we'll move into pop, which requires a lot of music theory. Okay, so I got a lot to cover, but it's doable. So I'm going to be really quick. So my friend Trizza at theproducerkit.com, I'm actually going to link his website here, http theproducerkit.com. Click here for UK drill sounds. It's called Drill Up. So look for his kit called Drill Up because he has the drill sounds that I'm about to use. Shout out to Kraken. He says, here you dropped it. Thank you. Appreciate that. Thank you. Okay, so let's get into I forgot that quick. Oh, UK drill. So Trizza released a kit called Drill Up. So if you go to theproducerkit.com and go to Drill Up, and we're gonna start with the hi-hat sound. So drill is, I'll give you a quick history because it's a lot to go through. So long story short, Chicago has its own drill, which is based in gang culture, which is based in really hard music. And the way you have hard music is not only frequencies, it's harmonics. And it's about being on the downbeat of something. So that's why the kicks are like, it's very on the downbeat. It's a downbeat type genre. Then you have New York drill, which is a derivation of Chicago drill, which is, again, talking about gang culture and all that type of stuff. It was really made to create diss tracks. But New York drill is the same thing as Chicago. It's the only difference is their snare placement. So instead of the I can't say their snare placement. It's actually, they took a lot from the UK. So I have to draw it out for you to even understand what I'm talking about. Let's just draw it out. So let's open this up. We have the hi-hat, and then we need some kind of rim snare, like a quick snare, like this sound right here. Nothing too long. It has to be very short. Okay, so what we're gonna do is turn the tempo on 144. This is where kind of UK drill resides in. And UK drill came from what's called the grime scene, where they had those very chorusy type bass lines. And I'll give you an example of like a chorusy bass line you might hear in grime. Let's make one real quick, just so you know what the heck I'm talking about. So for example, in grime, you would hear basses like this. It would be a super saw that's like 8 voices, detuned, very low octave. Let's add a filter. Let's do low pass filter. It's a mono legato mode, a little portamento. Let's do one more octave low. Okay, and then you have some type of chorus over top of this. This is a bit of a harsh sound, but this is grime for the most part. So the bass is very gritty, is my point. It's not an 808. So you would have those types of basses. And that's where we kind of took the idea for the UK 808 slides that we grabbed from Pop Smoke and all those types of genres. So again, the main difference in UK drill is that the snare is on the 3 and the 8 count. Instead of the 3 and the 7 count, like we did in trap music, it's on the 8. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again, all these genres have little tiny changes. It's not like this massive change in each genre. It's little tiny changes that create genre. Also, the hi-hats are really important because the core hi-hat rhythm of a drill is that's I ran out of breath trying to do it, but it's just and just repeat that, and that's all you got to do. Now you can switch it up and then make it your own thing, but this is the core rhythm. It's not triplets. Triplets would be ta 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 ta. That's not what we're playing. We're not playing triplets. We're playing ta 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 ta. It's a different type of bounce. Oops, I didn't count out the snare. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hold on. The pattern got cut off. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's it. That's drill. This is the drill formula. I just gave you millions of dollars of advice by just showing you how simple it was. But this is what I mean. Once you know the basics, then you'll know how to get to the next level. So this is the real rhythm of UK drill. Now, the main difference between UK drill and New York drill, it's kind of a debate because people who didn't come from UK didn't understand the timing. And I can get into everything about everything about everything. I don't want to confuse you guys. But this is the more New York drill influence 808 because the first snare is on the three. So it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Whereas in the actual UK, they didn't put that first snare on the three. They would put it on the 4.5. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8. So here's the difference between UK, just so you guys can hear the difference. And my theory as to why it didn't work out this way for America is because America, we're so conditioned to hear music on that three and the seven count that we're not used to the timing of the UK drill. So here's the UK sound. It's on the four and. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, and 5, 6, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's the UK bounce. It's a little awkward because in America, we don't have dance moves that really go with that rhythm. So that's why we don't really get with that bounce. So what I think Pop Smoke and all them made popular was in a smart idea is how to combine UK drill with American sounds. This is why I said Chicago drill and UK drill and all these types of stuff kind of merge into one thing. So now when we go to the New York drill, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, but the key is the kick pattern. So another key element for drill is a very dominant kick. We're not really focused on the 808. It's actually more so about the dominant kick. So we need a kick that has a lot of sub in it, like 60 hertz in it. So we need something that knocks. Let me pick one. Like this last one here. So we're gonna add this in. So with this one, the only place you really have to have your kick is again on the downbeat, because that's what creates quote unquote hardness. And then at the end, when we have those overlapping like Chicago, so it's boom, 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 boom. Okay, so that's the only place we really need to have the kick. So it's very spread out. So with the hi-hat, it's a little long, so I'm just gonna fade it out. Okay, so now we just gotta get to the 808 slide, which most people know. And I'll show you how to get that kind of reverse sound too. So what we're gonna do first is, actually I'm trying to think what we want first, 808s or the melody? Probably the melody. So for this type of Pop Smoke sound, you're gonna go for reverse. Now Drake does reverse piano. For Pop Smoke is reverse guitar. So we wanna go for, trying to think of what FL Studio has for guitar. Let's go to PAX. Let's go to instruments. I think they have a guitar in here somewhere. Let's do Strat and let's do position A. Let's try this out. Okay, let's see something. So I'll show you how to print this to audio and then reverse it so it all makes sense. 808s, it's called, they're called 808s because it comes from a drum machine called a Roland TR-808. It was a machine that had a lot of different drum sounds in it, but the most popular sound was the bass sound, so we just called it the 808 bass. But it came from a drum machine, aka a drum kit back in the day, called the Roland TR-808. That's where the name came from. It's from Roland. Okay, so let's turn this down and let's start adding notes, and then I'll show you how to think backwards with melody. So. So that's the melody that you, but it's reversed. So I'm just gonna repeat that. Oops. Of course, when I go to record, everything's wrong. We all do it. Oh, I did it again. Oh my goodness. What's that meme of when you go to record, everything messes up? There we go. One, two. Okay, so now that we have that forward, let's go to the actual guitar. Go to your cog icon. Go to your wrench tool. Let's go to monophonic mode. So this creates like a pitch bend. And then now when we play the notes, it should slur when we have overlapping notes. Okay, so the only thing that needs quantized is this last note. Let's hit Alt Q to quantize. Let's make sure these last two quantize. I know I'm moving a little quickly here, but this is more technical stuff. Just making sure the notes don't overlap so that they don't create that slide effect. And again, we could, you know, add a bunch of effects to the sound and reverb and all this type of stuff. Let's print it to audio first, and then I'll show you how to reverse it. Now, one way some people like to do it is they reverse the MIDI first. Okay, so if you have chords and you're going like this, I forgot we had that effect on, but if you play chords one way and you wanted to reverse the audio to play the chords the right way but backwards, you would have to flip the MIDI. So we're gonna go to the tools and we're gonna flip horizontally. And this should, I think, take it off the preserved start time. We'll keep it the way it should be, I think. So yeah, take that option off, hit accept. Now this should work. If not, hold on, let me slide this over, make sure I'm not tripping here, because this should line up. I don't know, I may need that button on, but until then, let's reverse it. And then right click, go to consolidate this track. From track start, now we have it. And then we can go into the channel settings and then reverse what we just reversed the MIDI. So now two negatives make a positive. Okay, so that's how you can play stuff. Now my brain's getting tricked. Okay, that's how you can play stuff backwards, but it sounds like it's playing it forward. Okay, let me try one more thing, because maybe that option was important that we did the reverse. So let me try one more thing. I just want to see if that changes the timing, because I never noticed the setting. Preserve timing. That looks like it's wrong though, if we preserve timing. Yeah, it looks wrong. So anyway, again, flip the MIDI horizontal, right click, consolidate this track from track start. Now you will have the audio, but then you have to reverse the audio again. So go to channel settings in the top left and just reverse it. A little bit offbeat, so what we want to do is go to snap the grid, go to a smaller increment, and then start using the grid to help us line up this audio. So visually I could see that this part right here is a little too late, so let's hit Alt, let's grab the slip tool and just left click and drag it over. And it gets a little awkward because of the time gaps, so you might have to time stretch a couple parts. Like this last piece, I have the time stretch. I'm gonna move extremely fast here, because again, this is beyond the scope of the video. I'm just showing you the little stuff that you have to do. We're gonna go to stretch mode, hit Alt, just make sure that stretches all the way to there. See how the pitch changed? We need to go back to the top left, channel settings, put it on time stretch mode, so it doesn't change the pitch. Now we have a melody that we created forwards, but we can hear it backwards and it still sounds the way we wanted it. So that's how you do it. Edison, it's the same functions, same exact functions. So now we're gonna make this sound bigger because right now it sounds small because it's an audio file. So let's go to all our sounds, highlight all these, hit Control L. We're gonna send them to the mixer. And let's start adding effects to this guitar. So I'm gonna add direct effects. So let's go to Fruity Delay 3. We're gonna add like a bounciness to the guitar. We're gonna go to wet level, turn it to about 50%. I'm moving quickly here because this is not mandatory. This is more creative. So that's the sound we get. Let's pull the wet level down a bit. So delay is important for the sound, like violins and any string sounds, because you're filling in those gaps, because there's so many gaps. Now I'm going to use a reverb that I like. It's called Valhalla Vintage Verb. You don't need this. You could use the Fruity Reverb too. I just don't really like the sound of Fruity Reverb too. Just mess with your mix level here. Now the pitch bend could have been better. But now it has that like Arabian type feel. Now we just gotta find an 808 that gets in this vibe. Let's go back to Triz's, the producer kit. See what kind of 808s he has. Where are we at, the producer kit. Let's go to Drill Up. Let's go to his 808s. Seven and then 808.1. So here's where I kind of go into ghost mode, and I might not explain every tiny little step. The point is, with the 808, we're just going to add 808 slides, and we are treating it just like we did when we were doing our, what did we do in the trap section with the what is that, Zaytoven's 808. But this time we're going to treat it like a spins 808 and give it note values. And then I'll show you how to do 808 slides. So let's right click, open up piano roll. So it's sometimes it's easier to play your 808s at a higher octave because you can hear the actual tone and the note of the 808, so you don't play it out of key by accident. So I'm gonna go boom. We're gonna do like the Travis Scott where it's spaced out. Boom, boom. So I know it sounds high pitch right now, but. And it's a little, it sounds a little sharp, so let me fix that pitch. So I pulled it down in pitch. The snare is from, it's a rim snare, and it's from the Drill Up kit at theproducerkit.com. So it's my friend Triz's website, theproducerkit.com. Click here for Drill Up kit. So it's snare number, what is this, 3? Which is like a, it's like a rim. Like when you hit the edge of a snare drum, that little outer shell thing, that's what that is. So it's nice and short. We're not using like a boom. It's not this big snare drum. So. Feel like the 808. So again, we're in a high octave with the 808 just so I can hear the tone. So when a boom. Let's pull it down to its octave so you can actually hear what it's going to sound like. Feels sharp to me, unless it's my ear. Hold on. Oh, it's because I made it. So your 808 depends. Again, we're going for more of a grime sound, which is like a chorusy type 808. It's not your typical spins 808. You would have to add like a distortion element to it and some chorusing. For those who understand what I mean. Then I'm gonna go wee 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 wee. Wee wee. Boom. Boom. Wait, hold on. Boom. What was that? So my brain had to get those notes out. So here's the trick. So I want to go boom, wee, woo, wee, woo. So what we're doing, and the reason I think they did this too is because they say woo a lot, which is ironic because it sounds like woo, like wee, woo, woo. We take this 808, we duplicate it, we pull it up at least one octave, we hit alt, we drag it to the left. This is what we do in Soviet Russia. No, I'm just playing. And then we double click on the note, and then we turn it into a slide note. So just double click on the note, turn it into a slide note. So it's going to go wee, woo. It's going to slide from this pitch up to this pitch for that amount of time, and it creates like a quick pitch bend, like woo, woo. So that's how you get that wah, wah. So again, copy all these notes, hit shift, grab those, hit control up, and hit alt, left click, make these a lot shorter, then double click on each of these and just turn it into a slide note. And that's how you get that, wah, 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 like the Charlie Brown teacher sound going on. Double click, make it a slide note. And you can mess around with the octaves. So there's a gazillion ways to do this. You could pull this down an octave and keep those up two octaves. Let's just try different stuff. See how it goes. Also, you can make these notes shorter if it slides too slow. Now I'll show you how to get an extra little edge to it. So this is like bonus homework, or whatever they call it, bonus credit in school. Go to Fab Filters Saturn, or any saturation plugin you like, and then saturate the sound. What's up, DJ Method? I like clean tape, but you can mess with this with it however you want. So now you're getting a boom, very buzzy sound. And you don't have to saturate the whole 808, so you can click each thing, and let's say you don't want saturation, you could just turn it off for the lower section. So that's how you get that wide 808 sound. Now, if you want to make it wider, you can add plugins like MicroShift or any kind of chorus plugin. There's a gazillion chorus plugins out there. But this 808 was already wide, so there's no need to widen an already widened 808. But that's how you get that UK feel to it. It's widening out the 808 and it's distorting it just a little bit. Okay, so then you level everything. She liked the way that I move. She liked the way that I, she liked the way that I, she liked the way that I, she liked the way that I. So let's say you wanted to go in a lower octave, you would go to channel settings, keep it on stretch mode in my opinion, pull it down an octave, negative 12. And this way you can create different sections to your beat. So let's make this unique. I know I'm moving quickly here, but this is more so like sampling than anything else. So what I'm going to do is keep, it's going to be regular in the beginning, and then we're going to go down an octave for the verse part. Let's go to channel settings, pull this pitch down. I said pitch with a P. Pull this pitch down. Let's go here. Let's go to make unique and make sure this is going to go down. Boom. So it should sound like slow down on the right side and then the regular speed on the left side. Make sure all these are unique, because if we change in FL, if you change one thing and it's somewhere else, it will change the other thing too. Don't mess everything up. Let's actually like arrange this like it's a beat. So let's move stuff around. So we're just going to move the slow section over here, the beginning section right there, and then bring in the 808s over time. And that's UK drill. Thank you, Rick. Appreciate it. It's all these plugins I put on my voice. You could tighten up the 808s, swap out the 808s, whatever you want to do. We'll be right back. add saturation to the, to that low end, see what it does. It's going to delay the kick a little bit. And then Pop Smoke will be like, she liked the way that I moved. She like, oh, I don't have reverb on here. Never mind. With some Pop Smoke lyrics like, I'm going to put it in the air, mama clean. I'ma put it in the air, mama clean. I spent 2 racks up a guess up in my ear. I'm dripping below, that's what I'm wearing. Chain cost a kilo, ain't ordinary. I forgot his lyrics. Let me look it up. I think it's from Dior. Let me see. Dior lyrics. Pop Smoke. I put 100 in the air, mama clean. What song is that? Hold on. Pop Smoke. Maybe it's called McLaren. I'm actually... what is that song? Anyway, it goes something like, I put 100 in the air, my McLaren. Whatever. I used to know the lyrics. And then on the voice, you would do the same thing. Add micro shift. I'm going to click on the wrong plugin. I'm actually going to copy these 808 plugins and drag it onto my voice, saturation, and then chorusing. Well, probably not saturation, actually. But the chorus, you would add a little bit of chorus. Something like this. Pull the mix level down so it's not eating up the whole voice. And Travis Scott uses this too, but this is how you widen out the voice. She liked the way that I move. Hold on, if I find the lyrics, it's worth it. Hold on. This is gonna drive me crazy. You ever have you ever hear a sample and you're like, what is that song from? That's the feeling I'm having right now. Cause I think the song's called McLaren. McLaren, I think. Ordinary, that's the song. I knew it wasn't. Listening to y'all. Oh, it's I threw an op pack in the air, my McLaren. Oh, well, we're gonna leave that part out. So it goes like a little something like this. And again, you always want to check your beats with the vocals and make sure you left enough space. I put it up back in the air, mama clean. I put 8 racks up, but gets up in my ends. I'm dripping below, that's what I'm wearing. Chain cost a kilo, ain't ordinary. I put it in the air. So always check the rhythm, okay? So that's what the Pop Smoke acapella could go if you have his acapella. I don't. That's drill. You basically learn Chicago drill, New York drill, and UK drill all in one section of this video. So I told you this would be a masterclass of how to make beats. This is not just trap. It's not just EDM, and it's not just whatever else. So I'll let you guys vote the next genre you want to get into, and then I got to rest before we go live at 9. So next beat type, do you want to do pop, alternative, or like pop, alternative, I guess, or do you want to do, what was the other genre we had, samples? So I'll let you pick. Now sampling is pretty high level, so I can't tell you that sampling is the most easy thing to do because it's not, requires a lot of thoughts. Okay, so let me open up a new project while you guys vote. All right, there we go. Save this as, let's do live stream masterclass, and let's do whatever you guys vote. So samples are winning right now, so I'll just save it as samples because chances are, but it's close. It's 53% to 47%. You got to get out there and vote. Come on, man. No better time to vote than now. No greater. This is your time. Samples winning. We're going to wait till we either get 100 votes or we're going to wait another minute. I'm going to let you guys vote. You said pop. Pop isn't. So alternative also is accounts for R&B as well. All right. Looks like Samples is winning by a good 12%. All right, Sample Beats won. So that's what it is. Sample Beats for the win. All right. Here we go. The last two genres. So sampling is interesting because it requires a knowledge of time stretch, music theory, sound selection, grooves. It requires a lot of knowledge of a lot of stuff. So the best place I've found to find samples is tracklib.com. And the reason I say tracklib.com is because the samples are clearable. If you're just finding random samples off of YouTube, snatching the MP3, and then a rapper picks it up and they don't clear it, the labels are going to have a big issue with that. The reason I'm telling you this is not to scare you away from sampling, but you don't want to spend 8 hours on a beat that's super fire. And then the label, you know, the artist goes to record on it and then the label can't clear it. So you just wasted all that time and the song will never come out to see the light of day. Because I know labels who literally hire experts to listen through records to see if there's a sample in it. Like literally experts who say, oh, that's from James Brown, whatever, whatever. Experts to the level where they know the snare drum samples. So I'm not talking about people who know loops and little grooves and riffs from certain songs. I'm talking about actual like snare patterns and drum breaks and all this type of stuff. So you don't want to play that game when it comes to sampling. It's just not worth it. We've seen the who was the Juice WRLD case. We've seen the I want to say Lil Nas X. Yeah, Lil Nas X with his Old Town Road. There's a gazillion records that have samples in it, but that stuff, if you don't clear it, it just becomes a headache down the line. Because what they do is they wait for your song to get big and then they come for all that stuff. Because they basically don't want to stop it from blowing up. They want to make sure the money's on the table so that when they come for it, it's there. And you don't want to be in that position. It's just stupid. But I can't demonize people for sampling. I just want to tell you, if you're grabbing samples randomly off of YouTube and stuff and you're not crediting those people, you don't want people taking your work. That's why you put beat tags on your work. So the same thing goes with their work. So Tracklib, basically all this stuff is pre-cleared. So if you go to put this on a record and it gets placed or whatever, then you can go to tracklib.com and credit the actual people and it gets automatically cleared so that you can use it and put it out. So we're just gonna pick a random record. They even have Bob James stuff on there now, which is very groovy. Yeah, Cameo is dope. So I'm just listening for a vibe, something that my ear catches onto. So with sampling, there's no rhyme or reason. It's just, what does your ear latch onto? It's either one thing or two things. True. And the one thing about sampling is you can't just use trap drums on everything. It just doesn't work. So I'll show you a way to kind of get drums that sound similar. So this... Oh, we used that. That's right. We chopped that up before. Loop this part. It reminded me of like Wu-Tang. Let me pick a new sample just so we don't have something we already did. That's obvious with, you know, a little riff. Also, if you're in FL, if you hit Alt or Option and left click, you can play the sample all the way through instead of it cutting itself off. Wait, this sounds like a Wu-Tang sample. So So, okay, let's do this like a Wu-Tang thing. So let's drag this into the playlist. I like the sample in the playlist as opposed to the channel rack because it gives me a lot more control. So we're going to grab this slip tool and we're going to hit Alt and left click and drag this audio to the left. And let's go to song mode. So we want to go dun, 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 dun. So we don't want it to go bring because then it's not the downbeat. We want it to start on that downbeat. So we're going to grab this slip tool, hit Alt until we get to that downbeat. So we're just counting music first. Before you turn your metronome on, count the music. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, and... Okay, and then it repeats. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, and... Then it repeats. So hit Shift-Alt, left click, do a vertical slice. We're going to slice right before the next bar. We're going to get rid of the excess. Then we're going to go to where it says audio clips in the top left, or you could hit Shift M. They both do the same thing. Hit this button right here that says stretch. And we're going to make sure the very end of this, if we hit Alt, left click and drag, that this lines up perfectly with that fourth bar. So now we can go here. We can make this unique as a sample. Hit yes and to save it wherever the folder is. And now we go to channel settings, go to mode, stretch mode. And then now it will keep its pitch and it will be in time. So if I turn the tempo on, actually I'm wrong. Why is the sound off? Did I count wrong? Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Wait, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, you know what? I didn't stretch it. Okay, my brain, we've been here for a while. So my brain, it's on 3 bars for 1. That's why it sounds off. Duh. We got to drag this to 4 bars. So the tempo is a little slow. We could either speed it up to go to like our double time. But the thing is, we want to go to regular time because we can use what's called the swing feature when we're drawing out our drums, which is really important. So let's slide this down to about 90 or 88 BPM. 91 is good. We're going to drag this to half. So we're going to drag this to 2 bars. Make like a Wu-Tang type vibe. And I'll show you a new way to create drums that you probably just never thought of. Okay, so now we have that. Let's go back to our channel rack, which is this thing right here. We're going to hit Control L. Send everything to the mixer because, again, we want every sound to be accounted for. Let's just turn this down for the time being. So now we need to find drums that match this vibe. So again, your snare drum is not going to match. Your trap drums are not going to match this vibe. Like that hard. It could. But you want to go for like snare drums that are a little dusty. So what we're going to do is go to... I'm trying to think here what style you want. Count has a cool drum kit called Count Drums Volume 4. So Count Drums Volume 4, he has in here called drum loops. Now the reason we're using a drum loop is to treat it just like a sample. So the difference between a drum loop and an actual one shot is that drum loops have multiple sounds stacked. So when I play a kick, it's not just playing a kick, it's going like tsh, tsh, tsh. It does the kick and the hi-hat at the same time, or like kick and a background sound. And that's what creates that vibe. So I'm just gonna go through these samples and see which one matches the best. I'm really listening to the snare and the kick. Kick matches perfectly. And I like that little snare in there. So what we're gonna do is open up Slice X and drag these autumn drums into Slice X. Then we're gonna go to the regions tab and go to auto slice, medium auto slicing. So now I play my MIDI keyboard, it will play the sample sliced up. So I just gotta find that kick and the rim sound, the snare. See how the kick is not just boom, it's like a cymbal over top. So I like that rhythm, but you know, it could be played a little bit tighter, but let's record that. So it's a little off in certain spots, and that's the one thing about sampling. Everything's not going to be super quantized unless you have a perfect sample. See how I'm early? Then I get a little better with the groove. Now another way to record is, I'll show you a new way, which is pretty creative. So we could turn this off. We could loop just a small section. I'd say loop maybe one bar or two bars max. And then what you do is you record one sound at a time. And you could do it to the metronome or not. Because when you quantize, it doesn't match up with the sample's timing. So you could have the quantized drums being perfectly timed, but then the sample's like a little loose and it sounds amateur if the timings don't match up. So that's why that in Ableton, they make it a little bit easier, but in FL, you just got to deal with that. So now what I'm going to do is record one sound at a time. And we're just going to put this on what's called loop recording. So I'm going to have it loop over and over again, and I'm just going to play one sound at a time. Let me show you an example of what this sounds like. Let's record into pattern two. Let's go to song mode, hit play. So recording the snare right now. So now it has the snare. Now I can go back and find the kick and just play the kick. It played it a little. So here's where you might want to do it for two bars, because the kick came in a little bit early and it cut it off. Let's do this again, but let's do it for two bars. So I'm going to start with the snare. Let's do this again. Now you go back and you find your kick, and then you start playing your kick. Now you can play a kick again. That's a little off, because that initial kick needs to be a little bit earlier, but you get the idea. So now let's find like a hi-hat. If he has one in here, let's find this hi-hat, and now let's record the hi-hat. So loop recording allows you to just create this really dynamic groove that you just couldn't get by typing stuff in. Now some of these snares are off, so you're gonna have to fix them. And again, this downbeat, this is delayed, so it sounds super, should be technical. No, I'm getting into the science of it, but really this kick hits a little bit earlier than the downbeat, so that's why it sounds off. But I don't want to worry about the minutia right now. So now you just go in and you fix the little artifacts of timing. Snare's too late, snare's too early. That's the reason why I start with the snare, because that usually determines where stuff should be. Okay, then you run it through compression and all your processing. So in this case, we're running through like a 610. Now I know everybody doesn't have this plugin, but if you want that 90 sound, we're gonna run it through a tube amp. A pre with a tube amp. And that adds that crunch that you want. You could add low end, like boost up on 100 hertz if you want. Now let's make this more modern. Let's give it like that Drake effect, so to speak. Let's go to our sample, let's go to gross beat. And we're gonna go to where it says the green tab, actually no, the yellow tab, which is the time tab. We're gonna go to quarter timing, we're gonna right click. and change that to a single curve. So now what it's gonna do is turn the volume down and create those Drake chops. So if we just right click, you could do this in Fruity Slicer as well. I just like Gross Beat, a little bit easy. It's a little bit easier to draw. Right click, again, make that a single curve. Now you probably wouldn't do two per, because then the sample doesn't last that long. So the volume dips at the very end. Or you could do pulsations, so it dips every downbeat. Instead of using sidechain compression, you could do something like this. And this will add a little swing to the sample. You just have to make sure that the groove is matching, and I'll show you how to do that in 3 seconds. So what you do from here is you mess with your attack and release time until you fit the actual groove of the track. Now you can add more cymbals in here as you go. We just used the drum loop. Now we can go to the one shot, to the percussion loops, to chop up the hi-hats, to add some filler sounds in here. Like the gospel crash to fill in some space. This sounds very Wu-Tang-esque. So let's add these to the mixer. Hit Control L. Now you can go back to your Fruity Slicer. You can find your snare, which is on slice 8. Go inside of Fruity Slicer. Whoa. Almost blew your speakers off, my bad. You can go in here, find slice 8, zoom in, just double click where you find marker 8. You can turn up the volume. So if your snare is too low, you can go to where it says amp volume, turn that up a little bit. So you don't have to have this all the way up. You could have it at 50% mix level, so it adds a very subtle groove. And the beat's a little slow. Let's speed it up a little bit. You can go to your drums, go to wrench tool, turn up time shift for all your drums, and now you can delay your entire drum pattern a little to the right, just to add a little more. Now some of these kicks are a little early, like right here, this kick's early. I don't know if we're gonna get the hyperpop today. So I'm just showing you how sampling works and then how you blend all this stuff together as well. So let's open up Trillion. This is gonna be the last instrument for today. Then we're gonna get into probably one more genre and then we gotta wrap this up. So let's see what we got. So the last key, another kick timing's a little off. I just don't wanna spend too much time on it. Let's go to Trillion. Then we're gonna go to Bass Instruments. And we can either go clean Fender or we can go studio bass. I'm gonna go studio bass all. Wait, studio bass full range. Then we're gonna find the root note. So the sample's not at 440. Gotta find the, and I'll show you one more technique using sidechain with the kicks, but right now we're just trying to find that root note. This is a little sharp, so the sample must be tuned down a little bit, the actual musical sample. That's why I said sampling is not just some straightforward thing. You have to know tuning, music theory. Now it sounds more in key. Thank you. So okay, I'm just gonna record, kind of improv the bass, and I'm going up the scale. And the kick timing could be better. Just don't want to spend a decade on it. But that's the work that goes into sample beats. So I'm showing you this process because now I got to show you how to combine all this stuff together and make it sound like it's one cohesive thing. So we're going to route all the stuff to one track. Now I'm going to move really quickly here because this is kind of beyond the scope of the video. But let's open up Fruity Limiter. And we want to go to compressor mode. And we want to turn our threshold down to about negative 20, negative 30, somewhere around there. Then we're going to turn the ratio all the way up. Attack time, you can mess with that. The release time, we're going to keep this around 30 milliseconds or so, 50 milliseconds. We want to route our kick. Now for this, we don't have, I didn't separate my kick, so that's why I said there's a lot to explain here. So what we're going to do is right click sidechain to this track. So all our drums are being sidechained to this track. And then we go to sidechain input, right click, select our drums. So what this means is every time the drums hit, the volume of the sample will dip down. And this is how you give room for your drums. And get that. Now again, the drums are a little whatever. Let's see what happens if we quantize. Might sound good actually. Only discrepancy is the timing from here to here. That's what's adding that awkward jump. But there's no way for us to be ahead of the beat, so that's why I'll just leave that downbeat out. Now it sounds more the way we're used to hearing stuff. And again, you can go to your ellipses tool. Now everything's not gonna be the same velocity. So I know I'm going over a lot of stuff, but you wanna think like a real producer here. Everything, when you play hi-hats in real life, you don't go ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta, you just go ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. You know, it's not the same velocity all the way through. Also, when you quantize, everything sounds computerized, so hit Alt-Right. Add some of that swing back. There's another trick. I know I'm going over everything. It's just so much to go over. So another trick for your kicks with sample beats, since back then they didn't have all the technology we have. So what we're gonna do is filter out the kicks by going to the kick, marker 4 and marker 1. We're gonna send it to filter articulator 2. We're gonna turn it on low pass mode and add a low pass filter. So now you're gonna hear like a muffled kick. So that's what we do. That's how you get that like 90s feel, because back then they had to filter their kicks. Really only the kick and the snare should trigger the sidechain. I just don't have enough time to be routing everything out. And then what else do we want to do? So everything's grouped into this track. And here's where we start adding compression and harmonics to make everything feel like it's one thing. So the first thing I would run it through would be some type of harmonic saturation. We could do Fab Filter Saturn. We could do Saturation Knob from Soft Tube. Let's try this first. See how it's making everything feel like it's one thing? Here you would add compression. I know I'm using stuff that isn't stock stuff, but I'm just showing y'all the process. have added some bus compression here. Take off the sidechain for a second. I would also probably run everything through like a reverb just so it felt like I was in one space. So I know I'm moving really quickly here, but I'm just trying to get you to what it would sound like commercial-wise, or close enough to commercial-wise, I should say. Let's do smooth plate, and let's send our melody to the reverb. And also don't be afraid to send your drums to the reverb, especially for these like 90s type vibes. And that's how we get that kind of 90s thing going. That's really it. I mean, that's sample beats for you. There's a really low octave bass. Let this play two times through, and then we'll move to the pop, and then we gotta start getting ready for the live stream tonight. So we could have done a lot more, like the timing, there's a lot of stuff we could have done, but that shows the process of sampling. It's not the most, you would think it's just dragging a loop in and just adding drums, but it's not that simple. I think sampling is actually one of the highest levels of music production. Now we're going to complete this live with pop, what did I say, R&B, pop type, whatever the last genre was. So we went through trap, UK drill, sampling, and now the last one is pop for this masterclass on beat making. So you learned, hopefully, a lot of different ways to do stuff. So in the beginning, I went really slow beginner, and then we moved into the more advanced type stuff. But I'm just showing you there's levels to all this stuff. It's not just drag and drop, which is fine if you drag and drop. No hate. Okay, so now we are going to create pop. Now this is a genre that, hold on, live stream masterclass pop. Now this is a genre that really relies on samples. So if any genre was a great example of how samples are important, this would be the genre. I know there's a better way to say what I just said, but first thing we're going to start with is Serum. And actually, before we get to Serum, let me just show you something about Citrus real quick. So the way we get like this pop sound, the sounds you're hearing, you're probably thinking it's FM synthesis or something like that, but really it's about the harmonic series. And I don't have time to explain the harmonic series. You could Google it, but basically, let's go to presets. Let's go to default. And so if you go to where it says oscillator harmonics, you can edit the harmonics. And if you slide this to the left, you'll see the fundamental frequency is the first harmonic. So that's why we get a sine wave. So if I start adding in harmonics, we get different sound waves. So a lot of the music that you're hearing, like those growl basses, all they're doing is experimenting with those different harmonics, the harmonic structures. And if you look at the harmonic series, you can see where the fifth is and where the thirds are and where the octaves are. I forget, I think it's 12 and 8 are our, where are we at? So in the top left, it tells you what harmonic you're on. So harmonic 12. So that should be one octave up, if I'm not mistaken. Harmonic 8, I think, is a perfect fifth. So this is actually creating two tones, even though I'm playing one note. So stuff like this is what the EDM guys understand. And the more harmonics you add, the more buzzy a sound becomes. And so those really dark, gritty basses are just them messing with these harmonic sounds. Now there's a gazillion ways to use harmonics. You could do even harmonics, odd harmonics. I mean, there's a thousand ways. So is there a way to clear all this? Let's do this. So for example, here's what odd harmonics sound like. If I could clear this board. Oh, you know what? It's locked to, I forgot we locked it. Hold on, let me unlock this. So to clear it, what you do is you click in the harmonics and you just drag it all the way down to the zero line. But let's lock it in odd harmonics, for example. So whenever you hear people talk about odd harmonics, they're talking about mathematical multiples of something. So you can shape this any type of way. And the higher up you go, the more metallic it sounds. So there's a lot of harmonics. So if I start adding stuff up here, it's going to be like, you can't even hear it really, unless you're a dog. And that's how they get those weird bass sounds. So if you're ever wondering how to create those really weird sounds, this is how they do it. Now that takes a lot of experimentation. And they'll automate these frequency modulation knobs to create those really robotic sounds. So that's how they get that sound. So this would be what it sounds like, for example. So if you're ever trying to get like the pop bass, this is how you do it. Now this is a very rough one, as you can clearly hear. Then you would widen it out with some effects, like chorusing. So that's how you get those weird growl sounds. But I wanted to show you where it derives from so that you don't chase a bunch of wavetables that you don't really need. So anyway, let's go to Serum. I know that was a long roundabout explanation, but the easiest way to write pop is in piano. So again, you could pull up FL Keys, any piano plugin works. I'm going to use Keyscape because it gives a very, very full sound, so we won't overly add sounds. So let's go to Keyscape, And the most popular chord progression is, I think, C major, G major, F minor, A minor, something like that. It's the 1-5. Let me pull it up. I just looked it up the other day. Let me figure it out. Let's Google this real quick. The hit song chord progression. And it sounds so basic when you hear it. It is, where is it at? It starts with C major. I know that for sure. Of course, I'm getting like 1,000 results I didn't get before. So let's just put the most popular. Let's Google this together. Most popular chord progression. And it's C major G. Here it is. Okay, so let's open this up. So I'm going to move quickly here using chord stamps because I don't have enough time to be explaining everything over again. So we have C major. And again, remember the difference between a major and a minor chord. So we have C major. Then we have G major. So we could use another major chord stamp. Make sure the bottom note is G. So C, G, that's the first of the fifth. We have A minor. So we're going to a minor chord this time, taking this out of that major structure. And then we're going to F major to the fourth. So it goes, the numerals are 1-5-6-4 chord progression. And if that's talking Roman numeral talk for those who take music theory and ease. Okay, so all we got to do now is just cut at each bar. Whoops. And then, so here's what it sounds like. Let me get all this lined up for y'all. Give me a second. Okay. Now let's turn this down a little bit. You've heard this chord progression a billion times. That's the most popular chord progression. Now, I can't say it's a hit song chord progression because this sounds so basic. But I'll show you how to make it sound more like a hit song chord progression. Let me look up hit song chord progression because they write in G minor, not C major. So let's figure out their chord progression. They do... looking for the one in G minor. Hold on, y'all. Clearly, I don't script these lives. If I don't find it, I'm not going to obsess about it. Forget it. I'm getting all these results that aren't the answer. 1-6-7. It doesn't give me... Never mind. Forget it. It's getting complicated. But anyway, let's just use this one for example. And it sounds very vanilla, but a lot of pop music, all they're doing is just adding a low pass filter to the piano. Like almost all of them. So if you add a low pass filter, you muffle the sound so it's not as bright. So it sounds like this. Then you add your favorite reverb. I mean, this is really how they sound. If you go listen to like the top, I had a reference list the other day. I forgot to grab it for you guys, but it's all it is. It's just low pass piano with a reverb. And then maybe they'll get a little more exotic with the chords. So let's spice these chords up because, I mean, these chords sound a little vanilla to me. So first thing I'm going to do is highlight all these chords, hit Alt-G to ungroup them. And then to make it more jazzy, in my opinion, I'm going to take this fifth and I'm going to hit Control down, pull it in the bass. And then I'm going to add the same C right here. It's still kind of basic, but at least it has a different voicing to it, so it's not our typical. Now what we're going to do is expand this chord type by adding in by making this a seventh chord. Okay, so that's what I'm doing right here. This one might be a little chaotic right here. We'll try it. Now it sounds weird when you have the fifth right. And again, I know I'm moving fast here, but I'm not trying to. And then we'll make this, what is that, a ninth chord? But this is really how pop is. It's piano going through a filter. And it doesn't always have to be a piano. It could be a slow evolving sound. It could be like a pad that goes into it. It's really about your drum samples and your vocal performance. So let's go to Make Pop Music has some really good samples for pop. So it's called Make Pop Music. And he probably has the best pop samples I've found. Let's do Radio Ready. Let's do Radio Ready samples. And let's start with our snare. So the snare is the main thing that sounds different. In pop music, it's more washy sounding, like whoosh. Whereas trap, it's like psh. We don't have like long drawn out snares like other genres do. Okay, so let's try these. And then we could build it up with more elements around it. But right now, that's the basic chord progression. Now, I'm getting tongue twisted. Oops. Now, again, pop music, we would put the snare on the actual 2 and 4, which is different because trap music, we put it on the 3 and 8 count. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, what's up? Somebody being annoying? My bad, Tony. They voted that you gotta be put on timeout. I didn't read it, but it's going off the democracy. The democracy is telling you gotta go on timeout. My bad. Oops. I don't like to block people on my channel. I just put you on timeout. Make it too hip-hop, remember, because now we're getting into the hip-hop realm. Let's find our kick. This might be too fast. Let's take out this bouncy snare. So they tend to copy hip-hop, which is boom t. Wait, boom. There's a little too many kicks, and I think we're at too high of a BPM. The snare is not giving me the tone I want. I need a snare that has a little tone to it. So I don't want to get into BPM science, but 128 is a derivation of 432. So 128 is a secret BPM. 108 is a secret BPM. 144 is another derivation of like the 432. So try 128 BPM. And we're not doing 4 to the floor kicks. If you're doing 4 to the floor, like Rihanna type pop, you want a kick that's not too overbearing. Hold on, fine. My ear wants to hear this faster. Maybe because my trap ears, hearing it that slow is just too slow. Now we're just trying to find the right kick for this vibe. And we can go in and make this a different sound entirely. So before I go to the drums, since I'm not finding the sounds I'm looking for, let's open up Serum and I'll show you a trick here. So we're gonna go Rhodes and then we're gonna add that low pass filter like we did. I know I'm moving really quickly here. We're gonna paste into Serum. We'll turn this down. Then we're gonna pull LFO 1 all the way up. To the right, add that to our coarse pitch and make this envelope mode. then make it a unison. Make sure you turn up your polyphony so you can play all the notes. Also, I forgot we tuned the Omnisphere down. My ear wants to hear a dancier vibe. That kind of slow weekend style is just not in my DNA to make. I think that's where the dissonance came from. So for everybody who was in here for this masterclass, I need you to smash the like button. So before you head on out, even though we're not done yet. Okay, so now let's do this because I like this sound better. So let's do that, let's record that. Let's tap that tempo. I don't even know what tempo. Somewhere around 124. I'm going to turn off my mic so you don't hear me slamming on the keyboard. Forgot I had loop recording on, so that's not gonna work. Okay, so turn off loop recording before you do this. Okay, let's record notes and automation. Messed up the ending because I was moving too fast. So now I'm going to get rid of the ending portion, and I think it was right here where I messed it up. Yeah, that's where I started messing up. So I'm just going to drag this, copy it on over. Now the cool part about this genre is that you can quantize, so don't be afraid to quantize. The chords are a little complex visually, but all we're really doing is playing F in the bass and then A minor. And then I'm just moving my fingers. I'm moving my bass finger one up to the next note, and then I'm moving my right hand with the chord. My bottom two fingers, I'm moving them down. So it's pretty simple when you're just playing it. It just sounds more complicated than what it is. Anyway, hit Alt Q. Now I'm gonna mess with the multi-band compressor to pull out some tone. We'll be right back. Because I know I'm doing a lot, but I'm trying to figure out how to make the sound more dynamic. So what we do is we move this knob, go to the top down, go to browse parameters, and whatever you moved last will be highlighted. So the filter cutoff is highlighted. Let's right click, create an automation clip. So sometimes in EDM and these other genres, it's not about adding a bunch of new sounds. It's about making your one sound do a lot. And so I'm just going to have the filter open up over time. Now we're gonna add some effect. Okay, so effects are your main kind of secret weapon here. So I know it's a lot, this is why I left this for last, because there's a lot of sound design when it comes to pop if you're not gonna produce on piano. And what we could do is layer with the piano, but in pop, there usually has to be some kind of production on some level, whether it's a vocal production or sound design. And this is just the process of sound design. Now we're gonna add either a bass line or top line melody to this. Then we'll switch that into a different sound. So the pop, again, it's a lot of little nuances like pitch bend, like meow. Like sometimes you might want to do a pitch bend. So in this case, we're going to go to the serum, go to the cog icon, and find a good pitch range. I think 6 semitones is usually good. Right click, create an automation clip once you have the pitch range established. And then we're going to right click, copy that first value, change your snap to grid to a half beat. And what we want to do is create pitch bend. So I wanted to meow and then go back up to its original pitch. So let's hear it in action. So it's a little slow, but I'm gonna fix that curve. That's why I said this gets so convoluted, because now we're in the high levels of sound design, like frequency modulation. So the reason this bass sounds out of tune compared to this one is because this one has a triangle wave using what's called frequency modulation onto this wave. So that sounds complicated, and it is complicated. So we're going to have the same structure. We're going to put six voices here, and I think I detuned it a little bit. Turn the volume down, and then we're going to have this FM from B until we get that same tone. So it's another layer of music theory. It's in the tuning from FM synth. So instead of bass, it actually had a better tone as a high-end lead. So we're going to use it as a lead. And I'm squashing it with a multi-band and using dimension to make it sound big, but then squashing it with the compression. So we're compressing a big image, creating this creamier sound. So let's say it's too many harmonics. You could, again, go back, and this is why piano is so powerful. I could swap this out. Instead of swapping it, let's just copy and paste, or cut, I should say, paste that into the piano. If it's too clawing with the, how do we get to this? Now remember, the FM is making that sound a little out of key, even though it's not out of key. See how it just takes a lot of malleable sounds here. So that's why I usually stay away from this genre, because they spend hours and hours on their stuff if it's not already pre-written. Now we need some type of bass. So what we're going to do is copy the chords, open up Serum one more time. One more again. And we are going to paste the chords into Serum, but only take the bottom notes. So we're only taking the bass line. We're going to take these other notes out. And what I'm going to do is hit Control L to elongate the notes, and then Control G to group the notes, and then just drag this last note out manually. Make sure it doesn't overlap. Now again, the same way we need to tune our synths, we need to make sure that it's being frequency modulated the same in order to get to the same tone. So in other words, we need to change this back to that triangle that we had, and then modulate the first sound through what's called FM synthesis, and then have it at the same amount, the same amount of voices. So now when we go in to add notes, it will sound like it's in key. And then I'll mess with this envelope. You'll start seeing me messing with the LFO to create a rhythm. Trying to find out why I don't get sound. Give me, oh, the volume's down. Duh. Now what's happening here is that the rhythm of the bass is not matching up with the rhythm of the chords. So that's why I copied the chord rhythm, so we can stay balanced with the rhythms, because when they're not in rhythm, it sounds crazy. So let's cut all that out. Let's keep it the way it was, cutting out those top notes. Pretty heavy sound. It's hard to hear the bass because the pads are so strong. Oh, shout out to Rafa Marino. Says great content as always. Greeting from Brazil. Obrigado. Thank you. What's up? Just trying to get a pop tone. Let's take out the chords. These chords are so strong. They eat up all the frequencies. This is another form of pop. Knowing when to take away stuff and when to add it. Then we're going to cover a drop and then we'll wrap this up, because pop is a lot of sound design. Let's add another pattern, and it's a lot of automation as well. So I'm going to go doo 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 at the end. And then we can go into a drop. It's very clubby. Also, I forgot one major thing. With the chord progressions, we're gonna take these, did we do it already? No, we're gonna take all these thirds or the middle notes. Actually, did we do it already? This is E, G, B, so technically the G would be up. E. So you would have to know where the third is for this to work. But basically you take the third and you pull it up one octave. Let's try that sound. So to save time, I'm going to use the already pre-made bass wave tables because I don't have enough time to get that monstery bass sound. I would have to turn the knobs 1,000 times. So I'm going to use the presets from Serum to do a bass drop. So here, this is going to take the longest amount of time, so I just have to muscle through it and do it without explaining so much. But hopefully you see the sound sources where I'm getting it from and the thought process. We're adding vocal chants. We're probably going to up the BPM a little bit. And the whole goal is to just make it sound weird enough to make people go, what are we listening to? That's the goal. Thank you.
Oh, oh.
Yeah, yeah.
Basically turned it to hip hop, whatever. So this is my terrible rendition of a hacked section A and section B. It still needs like a bunch of sound effects, a bunch of this chord progression needs a different rhythm, and it just is gonna take too much time. Got a little hip hoppy, whatever. But that's, you know, pop is pop is pop. I showed you a couple things here and there. I can't say that's the greatest pop beat I've ever made, but I will wrap this up because I have to take some time before we go live at 9 p.m. Eastern time to play your music tonight for song feedback. So I need a little break before we get into that. But this is the masterclass for beat making right here at BusyWorksBeats.com. If you want to learn more, just go to premium.busyworksbeats.com. We have a bunch of free courses for you. You can join us on the new premium experience, and then we'll have a beat mixing masterclass probably tomorrow. So again, all on YouTube for free. Just go to premium.busyworksbeats.com to join the new premium experience. We've trained over 700,000 producers around the world. Some have gone to work with Drake, Young Thug, Post Malone, YG, Ray Shremmerd, Ariana Grande, French Montana, NBA Youngboy, and a bunch of Billboard artists that are charting. So thank you for watching. It's Game from BusyWorksBeats.com. I'm going to go take a break. But thank you. If you could smash the like button, share with your friends, they too can learn how to make beats like the pros. So peace.